Blog Talk Radio.
Crack commando unit was sent to prison by a military court for a crime they didn't commit. These men promptly escaped from maximum security stockade to the Los Angeles underground. Today, still wanted by the government, they survive as soldiers of fortune. If you have a problem, if no one else can help, and if you can find them, maybe you can hire...
LCS Hockey.
Damashek, love from you, hate Damashek. Spins a yarn, any size, blast those jerks just like flies. Look out, here comes Dave Damashek. Is he fast? Not a bit, but he makes up for it with tons of grit. If he's wrong, what'd he do? Says he's wrong like we're back caught in two. Hey there goes Dave Damashek. Cool Cats Melbourne Kane is his fantasy team. When they hit the field, Bill Simmons starts to cry. Damashek, his best friend in his TV set. Steelers fans since days of old, set up red, sleeves, black and gold. Look out, it's Dave Damashek.
And we're off. It's the show that even the host can't make it through. It's the LCS Hockey Radio Show, brought to you as always by BackpagePress.com and by the number one non-updated hockey site in all the land, LCSHockey.com. LCS, backed by unpopular demand. I'm Mike Dell, are you there?
I'm here, Larry.
Yeah, see your phone, it sounds like a robot. You sound like a robot.
All right, well, I'll call in from a different line, all right?
Ah, yeah, try that, yeah. All right. Yeah, Mike Dell, Yeah, he sounds like Optimus Prime there, except, you know, much thinner. But, you know, while he's gone, I'll go ahead and do the monologue because, you know, what's the difference? It's the same audience anyways. All right, so the woman who claims that Justin Bieber fathered her baby says that a DNA test will prove that he is the daddy. Bieber's attorneys deny the claims and say that it is impossible for Bieber to be the father as he was grounded that weekend. He was grounded. You see what I did there? You see that, Mike Dell? You see what I'm saying? Because, you know, he's young. He's like 9 or 10. I think it's 9. But, all right. Either way, yeah, Justin Bieber. I guess you didn't like that one, huh, Mike Dell?
Yeah, not really, Larry.
Oh, okay. I see. All right, how about this one then, Mike Dell? How about this one? You might like it a little bit better. Executives at Sony Studios had a palm tree cut down after it was found to be blocking a poster for the new Adam Sandler flick, Jack and Jill. But witnesses say that the tree became distressed after seeing the poster and may have committed suicide after it was found hanging from itself. Hanging from itself. You see what I did there, Mike Dell? You know? I said hanging from itself. Uh-huh. You like that one? No? No? Alright. Yeah, okay. Hey, Mike Dell, are you there?
Larry, can you hear me?
Yeah. Yeah,
all
yeah
right.
I can hear you. Yeah.
Now, is it robotic?
Not really, no.
Alright. Because I got to tell you, when I changed phones, the monologue got a lot funnier.
Yeah, I figured that. Yeah.
No, it did. I was just...
Yeah. You didn't even hear my joke. What was that last joke? You didn't even hear it, so it doesn't matter.
I heard the last punchline, Jack and Jill hanging from itself.
Yes,
hanging
and?
From itself. Yeah.
Uh-huh.
It's great. Yeah.
All right. How about this? You ready for this one, Mike Dell?
Sure.
The other night, Glamour magazine honored Laura Bush, Chelsea Handler, and Jennifer Lopez with Women of the Year Awards. This marks the first time the awards went to a Bush, a pussy, and a country's first lady.
Oh, yeah, you lingered on that first syllable of country.
Yeah. That's what I like to call a home run right there, Mike Dell. A home run ball. That ball's gone. See ya. Goodbye, Mr. Spalding. We'll see you later. Huh?
Yeah, that was great.
All right. So a big show right there, Mike Dell. Big show. We got Cousin Brandon. And Cousin Dave, it's all things Damashek here on the LCS Hockey Radio Show tonight, Mike Dow. Are you excited about that?
Yeah, it should be wall-to-wall Damashek. Brandon Damashek in the first hour, and Dave Damashek in the second. Although I'm not sure when Dave's calling, so be alert, Larry. Be alert.
Oh, I'm on. No, there's nothing. I'm not. He's alert.
Yeah.
Because also in the show tonight, Mike Dow, we'll probably talk to the Ed, and then at some point I will pass out once again. So
yeah.
We have all that to look forward to.
Why don't you issue a formal apology to our listeners right now? Because last week we had Greg Wyshynski on. You should send a letter of apology to Greg Wyshynski while you're at it. And you passed out right in the middle of the interview. I had to conduct the entire interview myself. I had to come up with the top 11 Star Wars characters that sound like the hoo-ha on my own. You weren't even around to do that.
Nope.
And I would like for you to issue an apology.
I am sorry that I did not pass out earlier because that show was tanking.
Right, very good.
Yes. All right, so let's get it over with. Joining me, as always, is the editor-in-chief at LCS and a man that likes to have a cat on his lap to keep him from blowing away. It's the very busy Mike Dow.
Jerry Ferris, it's good to hear you.
Yeah. So,
is Brandon here already? Is he here?
Yeah,
Oh, we'll bring him on. Do we still have his theme music? It's been months since he's been here.
Yeah.
Brandon!
Hello?
I wondered where Jerry bought his pantyhose.
What is wrong with you? How?
Yes.
Jerry, that's horrible. How do you call yourself a man?
Holy hell, I need to have these women.
Brandon.
Brandon?
What?
Yeah, there he is. Brandon Damashek, it's been years. What have you been up to?
I've formalized my life. I'm now taking things awfully seriously. I'm now speaking in a very monotone voice. It is good to hear from you both. Good day to you gentlemen.
Good day.
Oh, thank you, Brandon.
I can tell you're taking your life more seriously because I've been reading your Twitter, and it's terrible lately. It's just awful.
It's been a lot of dick jokes again.
Yeah, for those
they
who...
They don't go away.
Huh. For those who don't remember, Brandon, at Judy Bloom on the Twitter.
That's right.
And it's JEWDYBLUME, at Judy Bloom.
Yeah. Yes, take note, Brandon.
Well, the lady and I had a lot of fun the other day. I don't know if you read her stuff as well, but she tweeted nothing all day but pictures of a monkey with a pacifier.
Yeah, I loved it. I actually retweeted that. Yeah.
Oh, we were both over the moon, and she found this picture, and I was like, you know what? You don't just do it once. You need to do this all day with silly captions. At brunch, Project X, just all day long. I couldn't have
Project
been happier
X.
about it.
Yeah.
And to make things even better, I had written a tweet earlier today. A mutual Twitter person, I guess, who follows the both of us, she writes back, mentions the two of us. She's like, you know, if you're at the doctor, it better be because of this. And what does she do? She tweets back the monkey. Tweets the monkey picture back. I couldn't have been happier about that. There you go.
Nice. Yeah, for the people who would like to follow Brandon's lady, at Artichoke, right? Or is it Artichoke?
No, with the D. With the
Artichoke.
D, like choked out. Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, very good.
You got it. It's because she's the vegetarian, you understand.
Ah, well, I'm a vegan. You know that, so.
I know. She was vegan for quite some time, in fact. And then she saw the light. And now, you know, it's funny though. She's a vegetarian, but now I've got her onto the sushi for quite a while now. So she eats fish now. So I don't know. I don't know if there's a name for
Mike
that.
Mike Dow.
Yeah, I don't know. But
let's just end the show because that was the best joke we're gonna hear. From Lanny, maybe
I didn't even hear it. So should we replay it or should we just move on? I didn't even hear it.
Come on.
Well done, Larry.
Brandon enjoyed it though. Hey, Brandon, I noticed in your Twitters though, you're once again starting to tweet about your job. Yeah.
Look, here's the thing. The nobody said I wasn't going to tweet about my job. We just said I wasn't going to tweet from my job. So in other words, I do not go on Twitter at the job. I don't go on Facebook at the job.
Okay.
I don't go on the Cousin Brandon ball. I do it from my phone now, you see.
Oh, okay.
So
for people who don't remember.
I'm trying to be smart about it.
you know, we've had this problem before. Brandon's last job had, you know, it was an issue that he was tweeting about his coworkers, and it eventually led to your, you know, they asked you to leave, basically, right? Is that what happened?
That's right. You know, I don't know if I ever told you this, by the way, but my coworker, the one who sat next to me in the cubicle next to me, the one that I always wrote about being a he-she, because, you know, she was like the 62-year-old woman. No, it's terrible, but just awful. The 62-year-old woman who really just a beast of a woman. Like, really, she sounded like she ate 5 packs of cigarettes for breakfast, and she was so androgynous and awful. Not a nice woman, but just a thing, you know. Turns out, like, I guess after they canned me, they showed her some of the tweets, including one about me essentially referring to her as a he-she, and she put it up to me one day. I couldn't have felt worse, but she laughed it off. But deep down, I'm like, oh, Christ, you hate me, and now I'm a terrible person. But you know what? Fuck that. I'm just saying, I felt terrible. Oh, because I feel bad. But you know how I did, what I did to make up for it, though? I pulled out a mirror, and I'm like, see, you understand that? You see where I'm coming from with this? And she said, he said, you know, you're right. You're absolutely right.
Well, that's so nice.
All is forgiven. Well,
yeah.
She's hideous. She's just hideous.
Very good. So all is well with the new job and the woman, and I know you were listening to the last week's show when Larry passed out, and but you wanted to talk. You had a story for Larry about the paranormal activity 3, right?
Yeah, I'll get to that in a second. I just want to say, first of all, yes, the new job is I really enjoy it. Number one, I'm still yeah, and this is just to give you a quick rundown. We've not talked forever. I am teaching this semester as well, and I really do like my students. I actually really like my class.
Yeah,
I'm still making fun of them. I've got one girl.
Yeah, I was going to say,
she is a goddamn bag of hammers.
That's nice. That's what I was going to hear your teacher say.
Can I interject?
Yeah, go ahead.
The cousin Dave is here.
Cousin Dave is here?
The cousin Dave is here.
Well, I guess
so many Damesheks.
Yeah, that's 2 Damesheks at once. I don't know if we can handle all this Damesheks, but yeah, bring them on.
Cousin of Dave?
Hello?
I was just enjoying listening to
Brandon's tales of how to get fired easily by tweeting out derogatory remarks about people sitting next to you.
What? I got fired? Are you kidding?
His brother and I both told him. His brother and I both told him on repeated occasions, what is wrong with you, we would say. You think that isn't going to come back to you? And by the way, he also would disparage his students, too.
He still does that, and he
disparages the kids in the class. Don't you think there's a chance somebody might see that and take issue with that if they're paying you money?
Of course, there's a chance of it. But you know what? Listen, as far as the other job, it's a self-fulfilling prophecy. You go work at that nonprofit job for 5 years, and you know what? Maybe you want to get fired. It was goddamn terrible. So you know what?
If that was the mission, then so be it. But that, you know,
well, then you know what?
But to be
chalk it up in a wing
call. To be surprised, however, like what?
Yeah.
You're firing me for that?
It comes in handy.
I want it both ways. I'm not apologizing.
And I know how to get fired too. Believe me, I'm somebody who knows how to get fired.
Radio. Dave usually just steals office supplies, and they eventually catch up to him, and then they fire him.
That's exactly right.
They never put. They just suggested I was grossly incompetent as a radio talent. They never. I didn't know they caught me for taking the post-it notes. But I guess Bonaduce never did that. And that was the difference between the two of us. So all right,
great
so
to
be
it. He really worked out for that show, by the way, Bonaduce. He really came on, made an impression, and they realized we really made the right move here. Fantastic.
Yeah.
This guy's
after
good.
The other host of the show decided that he would not show up for work ever again as long as Dave Bonaduce was in there. That worked out beautifully.
But
how are we, fellas?
Yeah, welcome to the show because, you know, Larry and I have been wanting to get you back on here for weeks and you kept giving us the hi-hat. What happened?
That's my way.
Yeah.
I like that. It's a game I play. You don't understand show business. See, I leave you. Yeah. I make you want it all the more. The more I say no, the more you're like, we got to get this Damashek. That's who he and Applesauce. You know it, too.
Yeah.
I told you repeatedly. I've told you separately and together. I'll do the show whenever. Now, we had a time a fortnight ago that was scheduled for a conversation, but life got in the way. Soapy,
yeah.
That's what happened. I'm a regular person. I don't have
that's right.
A butler and a maid and so on and so forth. I had things to tend to that were unforeseen, and I apologized. I think quite a bit to you, and I said let's do it next week. And what did I get? The hi-hat. Why? Because you had Puff Daddy Wyszynski on.
Well, you know, we can't plan for you. Who knows if you're going to show up? I had to schedule someone else, you know?
Oh, Puff Daddy Wyszynski!
If it makes you feel better, dude, Larry would have been just as happy to pass out with you on the other end of the phone as he was.
What about that, Dave? Last week on the show, I'm interviewing Greg Wyszynski, and Larry passed out because he drank too many beers. And
how many beers did you have? That's really the question.
I don't know, 12 or 13.
All right, well, then I can embrace that. Now, if you said 3, that would be another matter, because believe me, I'm not just telling tales out of school. And again, we could get Brandon's brother Mitchell on the phone, and he will have many stories about Brandon. Brandon's one of those guys who, you know, here's the thing with why society, you know, our society has to change because a couple of bad seeds in various things, you know, like it's the classic, you know, Adam Carolla is a big point of reference on this one as always. That's why you don't have glass bottles at the ballpark anymore, which are obviously superior to the plastic beer bottles, because some dope threw a glass bottle on the field and it almost hit somebody. Now we all have to drink out of plastic bottles for the rest of time. Same thing with alcoholism. This is the thing. Now it's like, oh, there's such a stink on having a couple of drinks, you know? Why?
Yeah.
Because guys like Brandon. Brandon has a drink and a half. Brandon's one of these guys. He has a drink, you know. Oh, hey, I'm talking about Modest Mouse. I'm talking about these boxes. Oh, let me tell you about Pavement is good, but all the stuff that was released wasn't their best stuff. The stuff you have to hear what they recorded before they were Pavement. And, you know, that's his thing. He's hip. So that's it.
Yeah,
he's enormous. He talks to you about this and that. But then all of a sudden, he gets a drink and a half into him. Then he starts carrying on like you've never seen before. And now people are talking about, do you see what booze does? Do you see the ills of alcoholism? And now all of us have to suffer for it because of that kind of thing, because his chemistry just ain't right. The booze don't agree with it, but he keeps on doing it. And now we all suffer. What happens to me when I get a couple of drinks in me? I become all the more delightful. That's it. That's the only change in my personality. You see?
Well, allow me to respond. First of all, Dave couldn't be more right on every point.
Thank you.
Number two, look, and in truth, what can I say considering, for me to throw stones at Larry for passing out during an episode of the LCS Hockey Show, if you'll remember, because this is the vicious irony, I have forgotten that while hosting my own lost show on LCS, I passed out. I forgot that I did that.
That's something else. You know, it's like it's one thing for Jim Morrison or what's Modest Mouse lead singer's name?
Isaac Brock. Yeah.
Isaac Brock. Like, okay, they like to get drunk, you see, and go out and perform. But they could get away with it because they had great talent. You see, that's what you and Larry are like when it comes to the world of broadcasting. That's how good we are.
But that's how we react to the
I'll
world.
Show you how
we have no
how,
talent. That's exactly right.
Howard Stern, he's nothing. Listen, let me show the world how it's done. I'm so good, I'm going to get loaded, and we'll take it from there, and everyone will delight in it. And, you know, 12 minutes later, you're asleep.
Says the guy at NFL.com, I'll have you know I was working at a nonprofit for 5 years, so don't talk to me about success.
Well, yes, listen, I've squeezed every ounce out of my God-given talent to get to a little scene basic cable channel. Thank you.
No, you missed my point. I've got nothing.
I followed.
I'm in complete agreement with you. I have not.
Well, let's try and get some sort of a schedule here for this conversation, because we had things we wanted to talk about. Yeah, well, you know, a sheet. How do you say it in the biz, Dave? Like the A block, the B. What do you do in NFL?
Oh, that's right. Yeah, they say they call it a rundown.
A rundown. Yeah, we need a rundown.
Why do they do that too? That's stupid. Why can't they just have their own language? You know, why do they have? I'll tell you what gets my goat. They do a lot of stuff on the when I'm on out in the field, like they say, you know, you're out on the field,
okay.
And they'll do a lot of the producers are all on headset, you know, and they're like, "Dave, do you want a headset?" And I say, "Keep those goddamn things away from me. What do I want one of those for?" Then people can track me down wherever I am. I can't steal away to the little beer tent if I'm off at a tailgate party or something like that, because that's where I'm going this weekend. It's to San Francisco for a tailgate. That's sponsored by the Kimmel Show. Yeah, it sounds a lot better than that is. But I'll be able to sell it away for a belt or two. But the point I'm making is this. This is what gets under my skin. People who aren't especially bright or gifted in any way feel like they are because of whatever their respective corporate lingo is. They drop words that make them feel important because we don't know what they are. Like, do you know what a post soup is? A post soup? What's that person do? Post soup. What? I said, what's a post soup? I don't know. It's a post supervisor. You never heard of that? And I've been around for a decade. What do I need to know what a post soup is? You feel good because you have your dumb little phrase? Here's the thing. I'm out in the field, and these producers will say stuff like, they'll say, you know, they do 10-4 and all that crap. But then they'll say stuff like, hey, do you have a 20 on Dave? And, you know, like that kind of thing, or like, hey, do you have a 20 on Jimmy, or whatever?
Like,
and what they're asking is, where are they? Where are they?
Yeah,
you know,
when are you going to arrive?
You sound like the doctor working in the operating room who's complaining because somebody's asking him to hand him a scalpel. That's how it goes. You're part of the business, fella. If you don't like it, get out of Hollywood.
Do I have a 20 on Jimmy? Or how about this? Do I know where Jimmy is? Is that what you're asking me? Because I don't speak English, thank you. What's the difference? What's gained by this insider's language? It exists only to make pretentious people feel like they're more important than they are. Do you know where Dave is? Do you know where Dave is? Or do you have a 20 on Dave? What's the difference? What difference could there possibly be between those two? Except that it's the jargon, so people feel important. Done. Now, give us our rundown.
Don't you think in all fairness, now let's say we're talking about the people that are producing and shooting these shows, in all fairness, I don't know what a goddamn best boy or a gaffer, I don't know what these people do. They need these lingos because they need to feel important because they're not in front of the camera. They're not the recognizable face. They need something to, like, sort of justify and make themselves feel good about what it is they're doing.
Yeah, but that's how insidious it's become. They're gaffers and best boys and grips and all those. They don't do anything. They're not actual jobs. But people are afraid to ask.
What is the best point?
You know, you're in the business. If you're in the business, you wouldn't want to have egg on your face and say, by the way, what does a grip do? No one's going to ask that. So people are just there, and they're I'm a grip, and they get paid hundreds of thousands of dollars annually for doing it. They're in the grip union.
Yeah, God bless the unions.
Yeah.
Now, we invited Brandon on the show tonight to talk about, just update us on his life, because he's always got something going on. He's a happening fella. And then he was going to tell a story about Paranormal Activity 3, and
that's right.
He's going to go to Disney World, which I find fascinating because I don't see Brandon at Disney World.
That's
in any
awesome,
way,
right?
Go ahead, Brandon.
I was going to say, if we have to get to one of these two stories, I was only going to say, I want to at least tell you the Paranormal Activity 3 story, but please, go continue with your run now. I'll get there.
Well, I was going to see what Larry wanted to talk to Dave about. Larry, what's on? I know Dave, he looks up to you like, you know, you're his hero. He loves you, you know? So I'm sure he has a
and
whole
I love him.
Yeah, I'm sure he has a whole list of things he wants to talk to you about. So I want to just check with Larry. Larry, what would you like to talk to Dave about?
Nothing.
Oh, okay. I just wanted to make sure.
What beer are you drinking, Larry?
oh, Well, you know what, Dave? After last week's, I got reprimanded and that sort of thing, I decided not to drink. I was drinking Labatt's last week, Labatt's.
I like when you do that. What? Why? Who reprimanded you? Not Dell.
We run a professional show here. You know, we can't.
Yeah, we're better than that. Come on, Larry, you're better than that. I'm always supposed
Wait
to be better than that, Dave. But I got news for him. I'm not better than that.
I was
going to
say, you're not. You're worse than that, in fact.
I know. Wait a second. When did I'm sorry. I did I guess we buried the lead then. I didn't know that congratulations were in order to Dell on the new property he's purchased up on Mount Pike. Who do you think you are? You are to tell Dell. To tell Larry about his booze. If that's how he gets ready for the show, that's how he gets ready.
He's diminishing the good name of fake radio. Coming on in ways.
You embarrass me in front of Puck Daddy.
I will have you to know such conversation took place. Larry's just playing it up. A little shtick, you know, for the show.
No.
But yeah.
There's no shtick.
How am I supposed to call Puck Daddy ever again?
I'll never be able to look Kaczynski in the eyes again. Because you passed out on our fake show. But, yeah, it's great. No. Hey, has Adam Rank ever passed out on your podcast, Dave?
No, which is remarkable because I don't know that he's been sober for any of them.
Now, what about Rank? He's been on our show at least once a month now for the past, I don't know, it seems like 3 years. He's always on the show. He's a great guy. He seems too nice to be, for it to be real. Now, is it all an act? Is he really just a horrible, horrible person behind the scenes? Come on, you can tell us.
Well, I mean, listen, I don't care for him particularly, but... He's, you know, between us, I'm not a fan of him personally, and you know they wanted the people over at the NFL were saying we want to get something out of his contract. You know, we're not getting anything out of him. So can you maybe use him a little bit? And I said sure. So I do the best I can. Rank's a delightful character. He loves
it's almost
his
like
food.
A big brother program. You took him under your wing, and you're
in a way,
you're helping him out.
Yes. Yes, that's exactly right. I think that Rank, if you happen to have listened to the show of late, I feel of course I enjoyed Rank a year ago, or else I wouldn't have brought him in on the podcast if I didn't enjoy him. But I feel he's gangbusters now. I feel like he gets it just right. I feel like
he's
comes
improved
up with
immensely. That's all I can say. He's very funny. I didn't care for him at first. I think he's quite funny.
Yeah, listen. No, I was going to, people often will throw out the comparison for obvious reasons. Well, he's no David Feeney. Well, listen, David Feeney's a, world-class comedian guy. You know, he's a funny guy, and Rank is very funny, too. But this is a sports show, so we're not sitting there just cracking wise the whole time. Rank is terrific. I love it. What I like about him is if you may have noticed, I like to talk about certain teams. I like some teams more than I like others, and I, shame the devil if I were ever to try and hide that fact. Rank's the same way, except his thing is all in Southern California. It's weird. I've lived out in L.A. for a decade now, and yet he is one of the very few guys who I've ever known who's that authentic article. I mean, he lives and dies Halos baseball and, pines for the LA Rams to return and stuff like that. It's cool. It's a you think that's much more of an East Coast or a Midwestern phenomenon, but he lives and dies it and he'll fight you about the Lakers and Dell. That was an interesting conversation, in fact, that I found pretty interesting the notes on there on the Damashek message board that you were weighing in on, the conversation on Magic Johnson versus Michael Jordan. Just sort of happened a couple weeks ago. And, he really believes that. That's not Josh.
He couldn't be more wrong about that, by the way.
Well, of course. It's ridiculous.
It is ridiculous.
Well, but who is Dell really? I mean, on face, is it really that different than trying to argue Lemieux over Gretzky? Now, if we start getting into it, then there's a valid argument to be made for Lemieux. But I think Dell actually will make a case for Magic.
Yes, I think what I took issue with and other people on the board took issue with is that, it's a foregone conclusion. Michael Jordan is the greatest ever. To even say that someone could be as good as him, you're an idiot and you have no basketball IQ, you're a joke, you don't know what you're talking about. And that's clearly not. It's all subjective nonsense. Kids grow up on ESPN and Nike commercials and they think Jordan's a god. But, you know, he had his flaws. You know, he wasn't the greatest. I don't know. Whatever. But
let me just say this to you. I'm sure you don't.
You're right on all of this, Mike. But this is why I say it's a no. You can make the Gretzky-Lemieux comparison, Dave, and say that, yeah, you know, you can make the argument for either one. The thing is, the way I see it, even the pros, even the people that play with Jordan, the people that play, everybody, they'll all agree that Jordan's the greatest. There's nobody who's not saying he's the greatest of all time.
There's plenty of people who don't say he's the greatest. There's plenty of people who will say Will Chamberlain, Oscar Robertson, and you'll hear a minor majority say, you know, Magic, maybe. I think there's
the minor majority. It's all the minor majority.
But still, it doesn't mean those people are wrong, or that the people who say Michael's the best. Michael, it's like a cult of celebrity with Michael Jordan, and no one even dares to question his greatness. You know, it's the same thing with Gretzky.
You know what would
have
ruined it? Here's an interesting thing. I do those NFL animation things on NFL. Here's what's great. Well, they're terrific. You should check them out. They're great for the kids. They're great with the kids. They'll love them because it's cartoons.
I'm kidding. They're fantastic.
There's a great NBA one, which is what if Michael Jordan, you know, we get, you know, the conspiracy theorists say that David Stern required Michael Jordan to sit down for a couple of years, the whole baseball episode and all that stuff, and they say,
because of the gambling and whatnot.
Yeah, the gambling. I mean, but there are people, I've talked to people who are legit, you know, not just some kook throwing it out, but legit people who say, oh, yeah, that's true. But either way, for whatever reason, he sat down. If he hadn't done that, here's the thing that would taint Michael Jordan's career. Is like you say he lost games. He, you know, the thing that makes him so great is that when put on the big stage, he always came through. Every finals he played in, he won. He won to the one NCAA final, he won that one too. If he would have been in the league and the Bulls had gone to the finals, which they probably would have beaten the Knicks again, in either of those years and played the Rockets, I think the Rockets would have beaten them. I think they would have had no ability to stop Hakeem Olajuwon.
Exactly right.
Who history is also slights him because just by the way it played out, his team didn't beat the Bulls, so it sort of has an asterisk for a lot of people. Like, well, those two seasons were the non-Jordan Bulls, so those don't really count. But the fact is, they would have never. And Bill Wennington, Luke Longley, those buffoons, they never had that. They fortunately for them. Well, the best center they ever played in the playoffs was Patrick Ewing, and he wasn't exactly, you know, he wasn't a dominant offensive player like that. Yeah, and besides that, like you say, he wasn't a winner. So that would have, imagine, you know, if Michael Jordan were 6-2 in the finals or something like that, if we'd seen him walk off the floor as a loser in the finals, I bet you that would change things quite a bit. But and by that same thing, we saw Magic Johnson lose to Ralph Sampson in the Rockets in the playoffs. Mm-hmm. We saw him get beaten by the Celtics, and we saw him get beaten by the Pistons, so that taints it a little bit for us.
And all those teams, though, all those teams he lost to were vastly superior to any teams that Jordan had to beat, you know? Basketball in the 90s
exactly
was...
Right.
But again, you can't do that math, though, because you still say the teams that got there are the teams that got there. It's not, you can't hold it against Jordan
in the finals
to win a championship.
That era in the 80s was much better. The teams were much better than when Michael Jordan was competing. You can argue that all you want, but it just was.
Yeah,
it was a better league.
This is the Toronto Raptors and Vancouver Grizzlies. The talent was spread a little bit. Now it's actually a little bit better because the influx of Euros has balanced it out. But yes, the teams were pretty bad. There were a lot of rubbish teams. Their 70-12 season is not hailed. I bet you a generation from now, people will talk about the Bulls 70-12 season much more glowingly than anyone who watched it. If you watched
that team,
it was not that good. They were good, but they definitely. I mean, obviously they were good, but they wouldn't have beaten the Celtics or Lakers of the 80s.
Or the Lakers, or the Sixers of the 80s.
But again, this is all really. Look, I mean, how do you know? This is what they always say about, like, when we make these lists about the best players, how do we know they weren't playing the same quality? Yeah, how do you do that? You can only say this is who they played and this is who they beat. You don't know. We don't know that a player from the 60s would have been better than a player from the 90s.
I know that the 86 Celtics were better than the Knicks team Jordan was playing. I don't know. I'm going to go out on a limb and say they were. I don't know.
But again, to do that sort of math, again, it's subjective. I mean, you can't really,
exactly right.
You know.
That's exactly the point of the whole argument. It's all subjective, so don't act like, oh, Jordan's who is so much better than. It's a disservice to all the other great players that ever played in the league to say, oh, he's so much better than everyone else. And I know, Brandon, you said everyone says he's the greatest. Yeah, because there's pals or a little sycophants.
But no, I'm telling you, too. Jordan seemed like an asshole, and I think most of those people would have said he was an asshole. And that's the thing. We all saw, like, you saw his speech when he was inducted in the Hall of Fame, whatever. I mean, let's face it, he's not the most likable guy in the world. And they always said that throughout his career he wasn't a likable guy.
The whole point I wanted to make was, yes, Jordan probably is the best. I have no problem with someone saying he's the best. But just, you know, acting like there's no debate or criticizing people who want to suggest someone else might be just as good. You know, I don't think you need to do that. Yeah.
I think it's interesting. You're right. But I did resent the comments on the message board saying that was phony and that argument that stunk of staged sports radio debate. Go screw. That's what I say.
Yeah.
I say go spin.
Did that really happen? Somebody thought of
Rank was doing Well, he seemed to be playing a
If anybody has listened to the show, though, you know, like, I'm sorry. If one thing, like, yeah, of course, the whole boss thing, sure, fine, that shtick. But come on. I mean, if anything, it's genuine. It's two guys that like one another that are just bullshit. How do people walk? That's terrible. People are too jaded. I don't know what to say about that. That's ridiculous.
Let me just stop the discussion right here for a moment. Let me just see if Larry's still conscious. Larry?
Yeah.
No, he's there. He's there.
Huh? Are you bored, Larry? I don't want that to happen. I apologize. What you mean?
The only thing worse than hockey talk is basketball talk.
What should we talk about, fella? What do you? Whatever you want to talk about, movies.
Yeah,
you name it.
Pick the topic, Larry. What would you like to talk about?
I don't know. Nothing.
Let me tell you my story, and then I'll be gone, and then you guys can talk sports or whatever.
All right.
Well, first let me ask. I know. Larry saw Paranormal Activity 3. Dave, did you see this movie?
I haven't seen a movie in the theater in about 3 years.
You're aware that there's a series called Paranormal Activity that exists.
Don't give me the...
Okay, all right, fine. Let's just... Okay, fine. Good enough. By the way, the lady and I, who also loves the horror movies, apparently like Larry's woman, we were watching the Netflix the other night. There's a movie on there. It's called, like, Paranormal Happenings. Paranormal Entity, that's the one.
I own that.
I'm like, are you goddamn... Are you fucking kidding? Why do you own it? It's terrible.
I bought it blindly out of the $5 bin at Walmart one day.
Look, they use the same fonts. It's awful. We watched half and we're like, turn this off. It is so goddamn bad. Anyway.
Why do people like watching horror movies? What is good about horror movies? Why do people choose to upset themselves like that?
It's for the same reason that people like to go on a roller coaster. They like to be scared. They like that adrenaline.
No, I think there's
no.
I think the feeling in your belly and the racing around on the tracks and the motion and stuff. I love a roller coaster. It's scary, but that doesn't get it done. The word to describe it is not only scary. There are a lot of adjectives that make it a pleasurable thing, and you can laugh at it. When you're in a scary movie that's really truly petrifying, I hate that. I used to like to do it, and I look back and think, what the hell was I thinking? What do I want to see?
Because
this guy
it makes me
crazy.
It's the oldest. It goes back to the it's sex. It's because a guy wants a lady to jump into his lap and say, protect me, and I'm going to go home and I'm going to put it to you for good. That's all it is.
Brandon, why do you keep texting me asking me to watch horror movies with you then?
What's that about?
I think you're lovely. I think you're a lovely
man. Fair enough.
So let me just tell you this story. I'll try to be quick about it. It's opening night, Paranormal Activity 3. Me and the lady, we decide, yeah, she loves the horror movies. Let's go to the theater. We're going to go see it. We go in there. It's a Friday night. Now, Dave just said he's not been
to a movie
forever.
It's the place to be in Harrisburg, PA on a Friday
night. It absolutely is. It's all a buzz. There's an opening. The mayor's assistant came. Red carpet treatment for everyone. Yingling aplenty. We're there, and you can imagine a Friday night. Who shows up at movie theaters? It's teenagers, because, you know, that's what you do. You go to the movies. We go into this goddamn movie. It's littered with people that just won't shut the fuck up. It just the entire time. And I'm like, and again, if you've seen any of the Paranormal Activity movies, it's long, extended periods of silence followed by, you know, those moments. And it's terrifying, but it's formulaic. Fine, that's what they do. Sitting to my immediate left is three giggling cunts that won't shut the fuck up the entire movie. They won't shut up. They're talking the entire movie, clearly scared, but that's how they, you know, they deal with their fear by kind of talking, you know, we're making jokes. Three rows up from us, there's some 50-year-old guy on a cell phone texting the entire time. So I've got that to the left of me, that in front of me. And then right behind the lady, there's these three women, three grown women that won't shut up. And the whole time something scary happens, they're going, you know, doing this noise the whole time. You know, don't go in there, like, no, trying to destroy. So this is going on for about an hour, and the lady and I, we're just trying to watch this movie and trying to get into it, and it's terrifying, but we can't really give ourselves over to it because, of course, we're distracted the whole time. I've got the three girls to my right, the three girls behind her, the guys text me. It just doesn't end. It keeps going on and on. And yet, you know, we're still petrified by these moments of, like Larry was describing. So it's an hour into the movie, and all of a sudden this happens. We're watching it. It's one of these moments. And instead of hearing, we hear, like the woman behind her just farts.
No.
And I'm like, she literally shit herself. She had literally had the shit scared out of her. Okay.
Wow.
And we looked at each other and we're just like, did you hear that? Did you just hear what just that was amazing? 5 minutes later, it happens again. It happens again. And we're like, this is great. But the best part of it, in the distance, up in the corner of the theater, we hear, we were so laughing at her because she farted and shit her. It was unbelievable. And it almost made up for this crowd of people that ruined the movie for us. Just listening to this woman shit herself. It was unbelievable. Couldn't have been happier.
But what finer testimony for the movie could there be? You know, like that should be on all the advertising, you know?
Yeah, it's a scary film.
I was pleasantly surprised in that story to hear that Harrisburg isn't segregated anymore. And that you're allowing people of color into the theater now. Good for you. I think that's terrific.
Nobody said it was white women and black women. What are you talking about? I said it was scared people. People who shit their pants and people who don't shit their pants.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It was a white woman. Could just as well have been my sister visiting from Chicago.
Mm-hmm. Don't go in there, girl. I hate to tell you, it was a white woman who made these.
I just assumed it was Marla Gibbs. I don't know.
She was moving on up. She wasn't.
Well, Brandon, that was a thrilling story. Thanks for sharing.
Well, I'm glad you enjoyed it. I had to impart that upon you. I have to go. I really do.
Well, all right.
I just wanted to share that yarn with you, fellas, before I got out for the
Brandon, what do you give the Paranormal Activity on a 1 to 10? Like, did you enjoy it?
I don't know. That's tough. Maybe it's not a great movie, but it's not bad. But maybe a 7.
All right, get the hell out of here.
Yeah,
the letter
gave it a 9.5.
He's retarded.
It was one of the scariest movies I've ever seen.
Well, there you go.
Terrifying.
Well, yeah. Anyway, I really do have to run, but it was good talking to all you fellas, Cousin Dave.
Brandon really has to go. He has to go tweet out the social security numbers of some of his coworkers.
Listen, if I don't write 140 characters about my dick, then who's going to?
Once again, at Judy Bloom, you can follow yourself. At Judy Bloom.
All right, fellas, take care. Nice talking to you all. Oh, by the way, I didn't even talk about Penn State. You're very lucky.
Well, I don't get it.
Very lucky.
All right, Brandon.
Thanks, buddy. I will say this: my new fantasy team, and Dave, you can check it out on the in our fantasy pick'em league, is Creepy Valley. So,
we lost them.
Dark times.
There goes Brandon, cousin Brandon Damashek. No, Dave, please. Larry's a big Penn State fan, so please, no comments.
Right. Does he just not like football discussion, or what?
Yeah.
Or is he really a Penn State fan?
No, he's legitimately a big Penn State fan.
Yeah. Oh, wow. Grim times.
Yeah.
I didn't know. I'm not making a joke either. I didn't know until today when I read some of the stuff about it. I just heard, child abuse, and obviously it's reprehensible and so on. But I didn't know specifically what the coach walked in on. He was raping the guy.
Yes.
He was the little kid. He was raping him. That just took it to another level of atrocity to me. That's some pretty grim stuff. Ugh.
Yes.
And if Joe knew that, and I think we know that he did know it, people say, we don't even know that he knew. How do we know what was told to him, what was passed along? Somebody said third party. Well, hasn't Joe already conceded that he knew? Hasn't he basically insinuated with his statement that he knew what was going on, but he should have done something more about it? How grim. Unbelievable.
Larry,
what has to be said, isn't it? I don't think there's
comment?
Much funny take on it.
No, not really. Larry, any comments?
No.
All right. Fair enough. Now, Dave, how are you with time? Do you have time to hang out? Because we got to get you to talk to Ed at some point. You know, he's going to want to talk to you.
Well, here's big news. Not big news, but big news for the people out there who tweet me all the time. When's the Ed coming on? I was talking to Rank about it the other day. I got to it's time for the Ed to make his appearance on the NFL. I think I'd like to get him on the phone and we'll kibitz. I just got to figure it out. They're doing a new studio for the podcast. They're building a whole new studio for it, and I don't think the phone lines are up yet, but I think they might be even as soon as next week. And by the way, I wanted to take more calls. We don't take any calls on the show, and it's a shame. I like kibitzing with people, as you know. And I want to get the Ed on at some point too. So I'll talk to him there. But get him on the phone if you want to. Now, if it's all right, I hate to be a creep, but it's coming up on 7 out here on the East Coast. I mean, on the West Coast. What is it right now? It's 6:45. If I could be helping with bath time and all that sort of stuff. I'm my little kids I'm talking about, not random people. But I'd like to.
We'll get Larry. Larry, what? Anything else you'd like to talk to Dave about before we get to the end?
Let's. What lists were we going to talk about? That we're going to do some listing and stuff.
Well, 2 weeks ago when you didn't show up, we were going to do top 11 snack foods. Larry was going to do his, and I was going to do my healthy organic vegan snacks.
Yeah.
And we did the list because you didn't show up. But Larry, do you remember what your number one snack was, Larry? I can't remember.
Fritos.
Fritos.
Yeah, Fritos. I love Fritos.
Oh,
regular plain Fritos.
No. I don't know.
No, I'm wrong.
They're not any good. No, they're not good. We're not talking to now. Dell, I get it. I'm in between. If you haven't noticed, if you look at me on the TV of late, I'm starting to pack them on. I'm getting a little heavy set. It's true. I got to be self-aware, and I feel like I'm running about 20-25 over my optimal weight. I can see it. I got the Travolta head going now. It's the big fat head going. But so I think that. But if we're ignoring, almonds are good for you. Whatever, that's a good, that's a healthy snack.
Blueberries.
I'll tell you what. Can I tell you something? And this ain't just nostalgia talking. And here's what they did about 3 or 4 weeks ago at the Kimmel show. I'm over there, and I'm walking up the steps. And they usually, craft services. That's another term. That's another Hollywood term, craft services. Why don't they just call it the food table? Why do we have the craft services table? What if you don't know, if you're not aware, how would you know what that means? Oh, the craft service? I'm not in the mood to do macrame right now. I want to stay. No, So I went, just tell me, oh, that's a food table. Oh, now I got now you have my interest. So
yeah, the snacks.
I'm walking up the steps, and I get a smell, and it is a visceral, nostalgic aroma that I recognize, and I immediately, you know, as they always say, it's true for me at least, when I smell something of the past, I can see it immediately. I see that where I was when I smelled that the first time. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And in this case, I smell the igloo, the Civic
Ooh.
Arena in Pittsburgh. Because I get up to the top of the steps, and they have at the craft services table, they have a big vat of that nacho cheese.
That's what I was
going to
say.
Nacho.
Yeah, as soon as you said about it, Civic Arena, I was like, oh, yeah, nacho cheese.
But it's not. Do you remember the igloo nachos? It's not runny cheese that you get these days. I'm talking that dense cheese. And then it give you not. And I'm not talking about getting it in one of those plastic, the transparent plastic things with the little cheese on the side. I'm talking, give me a bowl and put the cheese right on the top so that I can stack and I can flip a couple of chips over and get that cheese going all the way through so that they all get so that your chips get soft from the cheese and make sure you pile on those jalapenos. Well, this is exactly what they had. They had the old school nacho cheese, the chips. And the jalapenos, I took one bite and immediately departed to cloud nine. And it was just the greatest. And I was a ritual, and I went to many, many, many games in the 80s. We, you know, the old man had season tickets, so I went to literally, you know, 30, 35 games once I had my driver's license, in my high school years. I would go to virtually every Penguins game and bask in the glory of 66 Lemieux. Now, I would get a bowl of nachos in between the first and second period every game. And I had a bowl, and it's like I no time had passed at all. That might be the greatest snack item of them all.
Oh,
now,
so there it is. Nachos and cheese.
Do you know who loves nachos, Michael?
Who's that, Larry?
The Ed.
Oh.
Ed!
Yeah.
You're on the phone. You're on the show.
The hockey kid. Yeah,
I don't care. What do you want now? I mean, you
well,
got.
Why'd you call the show? You called the show, right?
I just got an urgent message. People kept texting me. Oh, call the Hockey Kids show. The Dave is on the show. I'm like, So I said, and then I said, so I called.
Yeah, listen. Don't start off like this. I don't like how you do that. I feel like it's almost showboating for other people. Like, I got it all. I owe it to people to be dismissive of Dave. Why can't we just have a nice conversation? It's been too long. How are you, the Ed?
Yeah. Is this the Dave?
This is me.
Listen, we always had good conversations, and then you got Hollywood on me, but I'm going to let you know something. Listen,
tell me.
You at NFL Network, I had lunch with Deion Sanders. He don't know you.
I'm not surprised. I've said hello to him in the hallway a couple of times. He walked right by me like he might not be on the same frequency as me or something.
Me and him was at Taco Bell, and we was on 99 cent menu, and I was like, Deion, listen, you know the Dave? He said, I don't know him. I said, I didn't think so. Then he walked off and got his limo and drove off.
Deion Sanders likes tacos. Never would have guessed. Yeah.
He got bean burrito, no problem.
Dave was just saying moments ago that Dave was saying that he wants to get you on his NFL podcast. What do you think of that, Ed?
I can say it's probably about time because I've listened to that podcast, and you're missing a lot of points, man. If you'd have had me on there a long time ago, I would have told you in week one that the NFL MVP is the Peyton Manning.
Wow, I know people like saying that this year, but
I said it in week one, and I even said before the season the Colts won't win a game, and they will get the first pick in the draft. I've been saying it since week one.
Yeah, I said the same thing. Everybody said
no,
I was
didn't.
Crazy.
No,
I did too. I said before the season started.
But you listened to me, so that's why you copycatted me. And then you had to go to America because can't nobody hear what I'm saying because you listen to their show on Thursday nights. And then you go ahead and then tell everybody else on Friday morning.
Yeah. What about that, Dave? I know
all
you're
right.
sitting around, you're listening to the intro every Thursday night, you take notes, and then you go into work on Friday, and you just steal all the stuff.
It's not the first time it's happened. It's not going to be the last. So what? I have a source that people don't really know about, and you know, I don't, is it going to go outside these go outside this podcast right now? I don't think so. I think I'm protected.
And,
good luck.
And,
why
and
are you trying
to
sell that? Oh, I said that was my idea. Go ahead, sing it from the top of the mountain. Let's see if anybody ever finds out.
Well, I'm going to tell you something else that you probably know because you listen to the Ed Show like a religionary person. Is that the Tony Dungy will be replacing Andy Reid as the Eagle coach. And I've been saying that since week one, too.
Yeah, he's been saying that a long time. Yeah.
Is that right? You think Andy Reid's going to get fired?
And they're going to hire the devil, Tony Dungy. The devil himself.
Wow.
Getting another job.
Why would they do that? They must, in these NFL circles, these guys seem to know, everybody seems to know everybody. You think they would really bring a guy in just to stand there and wearing a headset that isn't plugged in? What sense would that make?
It's very good.
You know what? Andy Reid got nacho cheese all over the front of his shirt. Every week the guy's eating something different. Every single week. But listen, I got to ask Dave something.
Go ahead, Ian.
You got your ears on?
I do.
How you been, buddy?
Lovely.
Well, see, that's nice. That was disarming, and I thought it was a sweet moment. Well, listen, you know, everything is it's just heaven. You know, everything's going great. No, everything's fine, Ed. I'm toiling a lot. I'm doing two jobs. That's too much for me. You know,
he's got
you know
all
what
the
it's
jobs.
Like to work. You know what it's like to work to have two jobs at one time. And,
well,
it's rough.
Well, you know, I'm doing my new job, too. I'm going to be Santa Claus at the mall this year. I've been going to Santa Tran for the last week and a half.
Is that right?
Yeah.
You'll be a great Santa. What if we do like this? Let's do real quick here. Why don't we have, I don't know, Larry or Dell come and sit on your lap?
I think Larry's the man.
I'm not no Penn State coach, so I don't be doing
that.
Oh,
no.
All right.
Yeah, please.
I'm that's the sort of stuff that kind of joke, it'll go right over the kid's head probably, but the parents won't like that. That's not going to be popular.
That's got to be one of the...
I'm not wearing blue and white. I'm wearing red and white.
No, I'm sure they told you about that at Santa Claus training, that you can't make off-color jokes like that yet, you know, in front of the kids, you know.
Oh, yeah, I know. I go, ho, 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 what's your name is, little kid?
Go ahead, Larry.
No, absolutely not. I said, no Penn State jokes tonight. I'm not dealing with them.
Well, Dave,
not a Penn State joke. You're helping the Ed and his training now. This is what he needs, some practical training. This is you. You pretend you are a 7-year-old Larry going to visit Santa at the mall. Now let's start again. Welcome to the Winter Wonderland. You're up next, little boy. Go sit on Santa's lap. Take it away.
Hey, little kid, what's your name is?
Larry.
Larry. That's with a capital L?
Yeah.
All right, well, what you want for Christmas? Larry?
How come you're black, Santa?
Well, listen, I'm black Santa. White Santa come on at 4 o'clock.
White Santa has better presents.
Listen, we all got the same little place that we get the presents from, because we got over there on the goddamn, South Pole, and we go over there and we get everything that we got. Again, we got these little midgets. They make all the toys, and they wrap them up in gifts. And then they put them up, and then they say, what do you want, G.I. Joe, or do you want Football Man?
You smell like cheesesteak.
Huh?
You smell like cheesesteaks.
That's what I have for lunch. Listen, we got all kind of lunch break and stuff. Listen, tell your mom she got to buy this package of these pictures. Smile, turn around that camera and look. Because, listen, I get 10% off every dollar your mother spent on these pictures. Tell her to buy that big package that costs $150 package.
$150. Really? The pictures of Santa.
that's package I want to sell. Because, listen, they're going to have memories of you over there by the firewood, and then you'll be over there, oh, listen, oh, I sat on Santa Claus' lap, and then he gave me some candy, and then he gave me a prize. But listen, if you smile real good, you go over that girl over there and see Miss Claus. That's my lady over there. Listen, you go over there to her, you get candy cane, you get that candy cane, and then you gonna forget what you told me that you want. Then you're going to tell your mom and them, and then they're going to get some presents for Christmas.
Ugh.
Mommy, Santa has something hard in his pants.
You're really doing that, Tom. Yeah, so that's what it's all about, just trying to move photos. That's what the whole gig's all about.
Well,
you just want to get
I gotta say, for, as an objective listener to this, I'm glad we did this, because, I mean, I think you're ready to go right now, the end. I thought I saw no flaws in anything you did there. Larry could have been better with his performance, but, you know, childhood was a while ago. But the end, you're ready to go, man. Was there any – the thing that is interesting, though, was there any issue – did they say, like, well, you're black, you can't really be Santa Claus?
Or no,
they
hired 24 Santa Clauses. They hired 18 white fellas, 2 black fellas, and 4 Mexicos. So we all got a share in the joy.
Mexicos, really?
Yeah, 4 Mexicos, yeah.
Yeah,
that's good.
We got them all. Nice. So then they... the Mexicos, when they do it, they say ho, ho, ho in Spanish.
What's that sound like?
I don't speak Spanish. I don't know.
Oh, very good.
All right.
That's what they do. Now, listen, did you take your little kids trick-or-treating time?
Sure I did, yeah.
Yeah, you had them on the shame report. Wait, and they were dressed as Batman and Wonder Woman and Batman.
Yeah, Wonder
Woman.
Right?
Yeah,
Batman.
Someone told me you had your kids dressed up as Kimmel and Corolla.
No. That's just silly.
That'd be weird. I don't even know if people would get that. How would you even make it look that way? A unibrow,
a
pillow
under
the belt, yeah.
All you got to do is dress the kids up like 2 bums. That's all you got to do. That's it.
Yeah, no, I thought that was... No. Who's your favorite superhero, the Ed?
Well, you know, I don't know. I mean, probably me. I mean, I do all kinds of superhero stuff.
Well, before we get into that real quick, but Dave, next time, you will always come on the show, and we always have these ideas we're going to do something, and then we end up talking about nothing. But maybe next time you're on the show, maybe we'll really get into DC versus Marvel. What about that? Could you do that?
I'm happy to do it. I'm definitely not the best guy for that, for an in-depth one, but I definitely have opinions on it. I don't understand the world of it, but I'm telling you, you know who to get on is Brandon's brother Mitchell. He's pretty knowledgeable about these things. But I'm happy to participate. I will tell you this, DC was always my thing growing up. I was Batman all the way from an early age. I was Batman.
I would be the Riddler. If I was a superhero, I'd be Riddler.
Yeah.
He's
that's the best one. Hey, listen to Dave. Let me ask you a question. Now, you took your children trick-or-treat time, right?
Correct.
Now, listen. Man, in my neighborhood, I took the baby around. The baby's 6-year-old now. Can you believe that?
Unbelievable.
I still got this
goddamn
baby. I threatened to drop him off at the fire department a couple of times, but I haven't done it yet. But
I can't believe that there's so much going on. I know there's a lot going on, a lot of problems in our country, but it still is remarkable that the authorities have not done anything about this. But all right, fine.
Now, when you went to trick-or-treat time and you knock on people's doors and you say, hey, trick-or-treater, give me some candy. How much candy did people give you when you knocked on the door?
Wow, they're getting – it's funny. Again, I say in these economic times, you would think people would be thrifty with their candy distribution. But no – they give so much candy. They just give a ton of. They like take more, and like the kids just took 3 pieces of candy. No, take more. They just push it on you out here.
Man, I got people in my neighborhood give me 1 Jolly Rancher.
Is that right?
Ranchers. 1. I said, listen.
You got to move.
Oh no, I told them. I said, listen. You cannot. I got to put my whole hand in your bag. And they're like, how old are you? I said, don't be worried about that. Give me some candy.
That's what I was going to say. It's what I thought you were talking for the baby, but you were actually taking candy.
Well, yeah, we both had our costume.
Yeah, tell me,
but I don't think those are the rules.
Tell the Dave who your costume was, Ian.
You tell him.
He was Chalky White from Boardwalk Empire. Do you watch Empire?
And it took me a long time to get my suit ready.
Yeah,
and
Chalky
White. I said, yeah, they, a lot of people ask me, who are you? I said, I'm Chalky White, Boardwalk Empire. And they was like, just look like you in a suit going to church. I said, well, Chalky White, he probably went to church. I mean, that's just what happened.
Yeah.
And,
Dave, you watch Boardwalk Empire?
Dave, have you ever cut your hair yet and you still got that raggedy hair, dude?
What?
The raggedy hairdo.
The hairdo is pretty much the same, although I'm thinking of getting a perm, but for now, yeah, it's the same old hair. Why, you're not a fan. You've never mentioned that before. I had no idea. You're always honest with me.
Well, yeah, listen, Mama Shet told me that she used to cut your hair with Tupperware bowls, and that's how she would, you know, for the longest time, that's how you got your hair cut. And then when you
I don't like when you talk about my mother yet. That's I don't care for that.
She,
and I'm not going to stand for it.
She told me the first time you went away to college, to Indiana University, that you packed your haircut bowl, and you had one of your friends, hey, man, I got to get a haircut, and you put the bowl on your head, and then they start hating you in college for that.
Well, that is true. That story is true, but I don't know when you ever talked to Mo Damashek about any of this, because I know that while she likes you and thinks you're a nice person, she's not interested in having a one-on-one relationship with you.
I mean, her play one-on-one like Magic and Kareem.
I told you I don't like that. I told you I don't like that thing.
Yeah, that's not good. Well, Dave, we'll let you get out of here. But one thing before we let you go, are you aware that the Ed has his own T-shirt from Backpage Press?
I love them. And I have, you know what, I've been remiss in not ordering one yet, but, of course, I'll be doing that very soon. It's terrific. Corey at Backpage Press. What a fella. I love that guy.
He sent me one with a crooked Ed man on
the Ed keeps saying horrible things. No, it's a fine T-shirt. And Corey is he's good people. We're going to do everything
we
can to help
him. I like him very much. Much like yourself.
Oh, he's a good guy.
Corey's tops in my book. I got to get me one of them Ed T-shirts already. I don't know what I've been doing. When is he going to make – all right, so now we've had – T-shirt for me, for David Feeney, for Jacuzzi Pete, the old producer of the Daves of Thunder. The Ed, what about the LCS? It seems like he's skipping the original podcasters.
Yeah, I want to get a Larry T-shirt, ASAP.
Passed out on the floor.
He's going to make a shirt where I punch the Dave in the mouth.
Why would you say that? Yeah,
a lot of
people been requesting that shirt.
No, I don't think anyone's requested that shirt actually. But
why would people like that? Who wants to see that sort of violence? Who wants to walk around with that on their T-shirt, especially
one of
America's most beloved football commentators, well, getting slugged by somebody? No one wants to see that. No one wants to. Who's that old guy beating up a beloved and insightful Dave Damashek, who told us? He's the one who told us about the Colts would struggle to win a game and would wind up with a top pick. Why is he being assaulted? Those sort of bon mots are going to be buried now if he gets beaten up and loses the power of speaking. Don't you see, Ed? Don't you see? Don't do that.
I don't know. Listen, I'm going to ask you a question. I'm going to ask you a question because I'm sure this happened to you in school. Because now, I know you was bullied all through school, but listen, don't you think that they making too much big of a deal about kids getting bullied in school?
Yes, I do.
I think that's just the baby-fied nonsense of school in America.
I agree. It's funny you say that. Every time I watch it, every time I see the stuff and celebrities speaking out, obviously people... these kids killing themselves is terrible, but I don't know. I what do I know about the connection between the two? But yes, as you say, the Ed. I was bullied. Nobody beat me up repeatedly. I wasn't laying on the ground bloody at the end of school. But yes, I was. I was a nerd, an outcast. I took my shots, and I couldn't do anything about it. There was no way I could fight back. I was a weakling, don't you know? I was a Jewy weakling. Who wanted nothing more than to go home and watch the ball game or watch Batman watch the Adam West Batman show. I took a beating. Well, listen, that's it. What do you? Would I like that to not have happened? Sure, but this it is a weird thing.
Don't you think that built character and made you who you is now? Because if you'd have never been a bum like you was in school, then you'd never be the bum that you are today.
Right, I wouldn't have retreated to the television, absorbed all there was to see year after year of NFL football, and be able to walk away with the depth of knowledge that I have unparalleled. You
and
know,
you
listen,
never,
with all due respect, you don't have what I have. Like, I'm going
to
say, so when I go on the air, the next time I'm on the air in the NFL Network, I'm going to say, I have a really good feeling that at the end of the year, the dream team, Andy Reid is going to be moved out and Tony Dungy is going to step in there. People will be like, how do you know? And then a couple months later, people will be patting me on the back and being like, wow, you did it again, Dave. How do you know?
You know what?
And I'll say, I don't know. It just comes to me.
Well, I don't care if you use what I say because, listen, I feel that I'm an extension of you. So if you need to use my stuff,
lovely.
You know, because
I often feel like we're the same person in a lot of ways. Yes, we're kindred spirits, that's for sure.
No, well, I'm going to tell you, this true story, too. This true story. Me and my girlfriend is watching, we got Red Zone Channel, okay? We watch it every weekend. Do you know that you come on before the Red Zone Channel?
I do know that, yes.
You do? Okay, listen to this. My girlfriend tells me, I says, there's the Dave. She says, that's the fella you talk about? I said, yeah. She goes, he sure is funny looking and got a funny voice. What's wrong with him?
That's not nice yet.
Then I said, he's from some other country or something. He got something going on with that. And then she see the Adam Reich and goes, who in the world is that ugly thing? That's the fella that I went to hang out with. You know, I met your friend Adam Wright. Did he tell you?
I heard something about that. He didn't want to. I said, like, did you really meet him? I think he felt bad, like he shouldn't, because you and I haven't met face-to-face. I think he almost felt bad saying that, but I couldn't get that out of him. So you did actually get a chance to meet up in Vegas, huh?
He was watching the Rangers and Angel game, and he was all upset. We was watching football. He's pretty knowledgeable. You know, he don't realize how much I know about the world. And then, because, you know, you've lost to me about, what, 96 times in a row in trivia, I think?
Yeah, wow. Yeah.
I've been in trivia since 1987, I think.
Wow.
I don't remember exactly, but all right, yeah.
I know, and that's why I'm saying, because the things I do, I make sure that people can't understand them.
You're very successful at it. All right, good. Well, we better let Dave go. He's got things he's got to do. You know?
All right. Well, listen. The end. Here's the big news. Well, let's talk on the phone on the NFL's dime very soon on the show. You'll come in. You'll make your comments. We'll have some fun. You'll catch up with Adam Rank, and it'll be a gay old time.
Wait a minute. You're not no Penn State coach talking like that, are you?
Oh, right.
Yeah, please. No, you can't be making those jokes. Please.
Oh.
Don't upset
Larry. Okay, if I'm going to be on that, if I'm going to, you know, be your friend again, I got to go to all these bathroom stalls in Las Vegas and take down your home phone number.
get started on that immediately.
I found it. I found your home phone number in the Yellow Pages.
Great. Very good. All right, I can't thank you enough for making the time for us here. You know you're our inspiration,
great.
Dave. You're the wind beneath our wings. You know?
Let's do it every week as soon as Crosby comes back.
Ooh, hey, this Friday he's coming back.
Never coming back, man. He'll never play again.
He's playing this Friday against the Stars, right?
I bet you $50 he don't play.
I'll bet. The Ed just bet me $500 last week that the St. Louis Rams are going to win the NFC West. And
don't hold your breath, Dal. He'll never pay it off. That's the Ed's way.
He still owes me a baseball
mitt.
All right,
Larry. Tell Larry when he wakes up that it was nice to talk to him, too. And I'll look forward to speaking with everybody soon. All right, all the best,
Dave.
Fellas.
Thanks,
bye
buddy.
Now.
There he goes.
Dave, you be a good kid.
Dave Damashek. And I guess they're moving their podcast to Tuesday. They're putting it up Tuesdays now. Is that right?
Well, I think it's the Thursday football.
Dave didn't want to tell you guys this, but do you know something?
What's that, kid?
His name actually Dave Sandusky.
You used to say his name was, what you used to say Dave's real name
Dave
was?
Montgomery.
Dave Montgomery.
He was Dave Well, he was Dave Montgomery, too. The guy changed his name like he's from the Department of Education.
Yeah, but of course, for our new listeners, that's Dave Damashek. Go to damashek.com, NFL.com. He's on the NFL Network, the Fantasy Show. Check him out.
I bet you $100. I bet you $100 he never calls me.
No, you'll be on the show. Yeah. It'll be great.
Yeah, I'm going to say he doesn't call you.
I don't want to do it. Maybe how come he didn't ask me? He just told me. He don't tell me nothing.
Well, yeah, here's the thing, though. If you get on that show, you can't be, talking silliness. You got to bring it. You know, NFL.com, that's the big leagues. You got to come with all the knowledge and the perspective.
Listen,
if I get on,
this is going to be the problem, though. If I get on that NFL.com show, I don't want them firing him and putting me out. I don't want to take him out.
Well, don't
take
it back.
Oh, yeah, you can't be saying that, Ed. You can't be saying, you know, swear words or curse words or derogatory
words.
No,
I know that. We on satellite radio right now. We on Howard Stern type stuff. We can talk and say whatever we want to say. I know how to be in America. Because, you know, when Dave had his show in Pittsburgh and the Adam had his show and stuff,
I never said
nothing wrong.
Yeah, you're always on your best behavior.
I know when I can work green. I know it.
Well, I think the term is blue, but yeah. You can work blue.
What else we got going on tonight? What else we got?
Yeah,
going?
Not really anything. Larry, do we have anything else planned?
No, we didn't even get to do our bit with Dave.
Yeah, Larry had a bit he was going to do. Do you want to do the bit now, Larry?
Yeah, I'll do it.
I don't know.
I got to get surgery on my hernia, man. Did I tell you that?
Yeah, you told us that. You have to get surgery. Now, have you scheduled the surgery on your hernia yet?
No.
Yeah, because you really don't want to take care of that. You just want to let that linger, I think.
Well,
how big are your balls?
It ain't in my balls, in my belly.
It's in your belly.
Your belly was already huge.
That's what I'm saying, Colin. It's like a fan that goes around and don't stop unless you press the button.
I don't even know what that means.
So you're saying your hernia moves from left to right?
No, it goes round and round and round, you know? And then, listen to this. I'm going to tell you something that's just making me so goddamn mad. I got 13 fire alarms in this house. 13.
Okay. 13, okay.
Now, one of them is way up in the air. I mean,
okay.
The ceiling's probably 25 feet up in the air.
I don't believe that, but okay.
It's beeping, and I cannot reach it.
So it's just constantly beeping.
Yeah, it goes every couple minutes. Beep.
Oh, it's probably the battery's low. It does that when the battery's high.
Now, how the heck am I supposed to reach that? How come when they built this house, they didn't put a battery, a lifetime battery in there?
Well, I'm going to go out, maybe a ladder. Maybe you can get a ladder.
I don't got no ladder, man.
What about... Yeah, you can borrow a ladder, maybe. Or what about the baby?
You have 71 TVs, you can't grab a ladder?
Yeah.
Okay, listen, how am I supposed to fit a 25-foot ladder in the back of my car?
Well, I don't know if you have to do that necessarily. But what about the baby? Can't he climb up there like a little monkey and get it? He's pretty agile.
It's straight up. What am I going to do, stack up a bunch of chairs?
Yeah, just throw them. Oh, you got a hernia. You can't really throw them. Yeah.
I thought about stacking up chairs and doing it, but then, man, it's like, what if the chairs fall over, then I fall?
Yeah, that's a risk. I don't want to take that.
Oh, did I tell you the baby punched a hole in his wall in his room?
That seems about right, man.
Yeah.
6-year-old baby.
This kid got so mad and told me I was stupid and punched a hole in his wall and said if I didn't get him any more chocolate milk, that was going to be my face next time.
Nice. That's nice. Kiddo loves his chocolate milk. Yeah.
Yeah, I know. So, I went and made him some chocolate milk. I was like, relax.
Now, did you make it with the Nestle Quick powder or the liquid or what'd you do?
No, we got the liquid. It's Hershey's. Hershey's chocolate.
Oh, Hershey's. Yeah.
Oh, look, man. Uh-oh, they said Joe Paterno is out immediately as coach. Yep, he's out. Yep. And then Rodney Erickson. Penn State Board of Trustees. Joe Paterno is out immediately as coach, and school president Graham Spurrier is also out. Assistant Tom Bradley will serve as interim coach for the rest of the season. Wow,
yeah,
man.
Had to be done, Larry. I'm sorry, but it had to be done.
Do you know that and it says also, they will be changing the name of the team to the Penn State Horny Old Men. What in the world?
Oh, man, we lost the Ed. What the hell happened?
Back on.
Son of a bitch.
Well, we got nothing else to talk about. I mean, I can get into the Penn State situation if you want, because what else are we going to talk about?
That. We're not talking about that shit.
Well, bring the Ed back on. We got to fill time.
He's gone. He dropped.
Oh, my gosh. Well, then what are you going to talk about? You got to fill a good half hour show.
All right, here we go. You ready?
Since the beginning of time, people have been making mistakes. But rest assured, if you fuck up, I'm going to be there to call you on it. I didn't do this to you. You did this to you. And so it starts! First up, stores and malls that open late on Sunday. That might have been great back in 1957 when mom and pop hardware stores wanted to go to church Sunday morning. But nobody believes in God anymore, and nobody should have to fucking wait until noon to buy Air Jordans. Yahtzee!
What the hell was that? That's Yahtzee. That's the Yahtzee report, Mike Dow.
The Yahtzee report.
Yeah.
And why do you call this? Basically, you're upset that stores close early on Sundays.
No, they open late on Sundays.
Oh, they open late on Sundays. All right, but no, you don't have a problem with them closing early on Sundays, just opening late.
Yeah, like, what's the point? I don't get it. Like, why do you have to wait until 11 to open on Sunday? What year is this?
All right, so that upset you so much that you shake the dice in a cup and you yell Yahtzee.
Yeah, Yahtzee! Yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah. What do you think?
It seems a little, you know, similar to what Dave does with the shame report.
What? It's nothing like it.
Yeah.
Next up, any douchebag driving a minivan with a Harley-Davidson sticker on the back, any fat ass who's too fat to wait till they get home to stuff their face full of hamburgers, or any jackass not named Austin Powers driving a Mini Cooper. Yahtzee! Thanks, Kenny Mayne.
Wait a minute. Thanks, Kenny Mayne. What the hell?
That's Kenny Mayne yelling? Yeah, that's him. You know, I told him I was doing this bit, and he decided he was going to help me out. Like, the Dave always gets a little special guest on his show that goes, oh, that's a shame, Dave. Kenny Mayne just like, hey, I'll help you out, and he just yelled Yahtzee for me.
I didn't even know you were a fan of Kenny Mayne.
I'm not, but, you know, hey, he's a fan of me. That's the point I'm getting at.
And you're upset at people eating hamburgers before they get home.
Yeah, did you ever notice, like, when you see somebody in a car eating, it's always the biggest, fattest, piece of shit blob on the planet, and it's like you can't wait 2 minutes till you get home from the drive-thru to start shoveling it in. Like,
so you're
are you that
me,
fat?
You go to McDonald's how many times a week? Like 4, 5?
I don't know, 7, 8, 9.
And you're telling me on your way home you don't sample the food?
Never. I never eat in the car.
Never.
No. That's bullshit.
Not even a French fry. Not even a French fry.
I'm not saying I don't have one fry.
Yeah. That's
but
right.
I don't open a burger though. I don't open a burger.
Yeah.
McDonald's is like 3-4 minutes from here. I can wait.
Yeah, you know, I haven't had fast food in a good 20 years, but when I did, it was like, I treat myself to a fry on the way home.
Yeah. So, yeah, Kenny Mayne, help me out. What do you think of that? Celebrities and all that kind of shit.
It's pretty good. I don't know if Kenny Mayne's a celebrity.
Any celebrity that books himself on the show and then conveniently forgets week after week because he'd rather masturbate the Ruth Gordon movies. Yahtzee! You hear that? That's the plastic cup of disgrace. Try not to roll snake eyes!
Wow. Oh, Yahtzee theme.
Yeah, it's a Yahtzee theme. Yep.
Because, you know, Dave, when he's done with the shame report, he says, try not to embarrass yourself, and he throws a paper bag of shame. But
yeah.
You roll,
yeah,
you say don't, try not to roll
snake
eyes.
Yeah. What do you think of that?
Well, nice Ruth Gordon reference. I like that.
I don't know what made me think of Ruth Gordon, but as a matter of fact, I'm watching a Ruth Gordon movie right now.
Oh, that shit. Well, that's it. Butterflies are free? Is it Butterflies Are Free? What would it be?
My Bodyguard.
My Bodyguard. Yeah, for people who don't know, Ruth Gordon was an elderly actress, and she was on an episode of Taxi. It was great. In fact, I think she may have won a special Emmy or something for the episode. But, she hired, like, Alex Rager to be her personal cabbie. And,
yeah.
It was a very good show, yeah.
But she was also in Rosemary's Baby, for one. And she played Clint Eastwood's mom in all those Any Which Way But Whatever.
Oh, yeah. Any Which Way But Loose, Any Which Way You Can. Yeah.
He's always fighting with Clyde, the gorilla, or the orangutan.
Right turn, Clyde.
Yeah, she was always afraid that he's stealing my goddamn Oreos. Yeah, that's
important. That's like the end of the baby.
Yeah,
exactly. Good one.
Yeah.
Well, I got to tell you, Larry, I had some fine work with the Yahtzee report.
I really wanted to get Dave's take on it, but when, you know, Cousin Brandon and the Ed, and it's like... You just can't talk to Dave, because everybody wants to...
It happens all the time whenever we have Dave on the show. We end up having a bunch of people on, and then you really don't get anything accomplished. But, what can you do?
That's the thing. Like, you know, Brandon never comes on the show, but then all of a sudden Dave comes on the show, and Brandon's here. Why can't we get one of the other fucking Damesheks on at this?
It's tough.
That's it.
Tough.
Just one.
Yeah. We either have no Damesheks or one too many. But,
Yeah.
It's the story of our life. But, yeah, we'll get Brandon back on, because we didn't even get to talk to him about Disney World. He's going to Disney World on this weekend, I think. He's taking his little girl and I guess his lady friend, and they're going to Disney World, because I just don't understand Brandon. Because last I checked, Disney World, that's the happiest place in the world, right? Is that what they say? And Brandon's not very happy, you know?
That's like me going to Disney World.
Yeah, it just doesn't make a lot of sense, really. Maybe it would be better we get his take after the experience. So maybe we'll try and get him on next week. He can tell us what it was like, Disney World, because I'm sure he's going to have a lot of stories. And hey, real quick, before my buddy Michigan Frank, this weekend, he might be going to a storage auction.
Oh, really?
Yeah, he's going to storage war it up. And so if he goes, we'll have him update us on that next week, because... Yeah, he was going to come up with a little catchphrase, like, you know, yep. Like, when he bails, he's going to say something. But I don't know what he's settled on yet. But,
Ernie and I, we were going to do this as well, and we were going to do the, we were going to go bang, bang, like, Cactus Jack.
Cactus Jack. But, man, that's pretty good.
Yeah, that's what we were going to do. But
Me that sometimes when you go to these stores, they charge you a fee just to get in?
Yeah, I think you got to pay before you can even go. I think that keeps idiots from just showing up.
Yeah, and do you remember how much the fee was?
No, I don't. I don't know.
Yeah, because I told him he was outraged at that prospect of paying a fee. So if he has to pay a fee, he's not going.
Then he's probably not going to go.
Yeah, so we'll see. So that'll be next week. We'll get an update on that. All right, bring the Ed on.
Bring the Ed on. Ed!
Huh?
What happened to you?
You hung up on me.
Oh, no, I didn't hang up on you. Your phone cut off.
I think somebody hung up on me. I was in an auction not too long ago. I be going to them auctions, bidding on them storage things, too. I got my own catchphrase and all that.
What do you say to Ed when you want to place a bid?
Here we go.
Well, I'd be like, we got 25. I go, yeah, nigga, what? What, nigga, what?
Sorry, Ed. Yeah.
Pay a fee? Did you have to pay a fee just to get in the door?
You got to pay a $25 fee.
Okay, I figured it was pretty
$25
like that.
For the privilege to bid on somebody's crap.
Yeah. Hey, I was watching
Here's what I did. Listen to what I did, though. I'm going to tell you something, because I got a storage unit. Now, I had forgot to pay on it, okay? Listen.
Uh-huh.
And they told me, hey, man, your storage unit is going to be up for auction. You owe 3 months plus penalties. So they wanted like $498. So I had Franklin, this was a while back, I had Franklin go up to the storage unit, and I gave him $25 to buy the smallest storage unit there is.
Okay.
So he did, We went in there at nighttime and cut the bolt cutters and took the locks off and got all my stuff out of there. So we didn't have to pay $500. I was like, that's crazy. Because they give you a code and stuff, and then they, if you don't pay, then they make you a, they suspend your code.
It's good thinking,
I thought you were going to say you told Franklin to go to the auction and, like, you got it back for, like, $50 or something, you know, but no, you just...
Oh, no. I would have went and auctioned on it myself. Oh, no. I knew, maybe they were going to get my stuff because all my football people was in there.
Oh, yeah, you can't give up the football people.
No, I don't do that.
Hey, football people. I noticed on your Tumblr page, vsusports.tumblr.com, I noticed you put some basketball guys up. Are those basketball guys just like half guys?
Are they what?
Like half guys. Like you get them from the waist up. They have legs on them?
No, their legs are... Well, no, some of them are like that. They used to... When that was some of the first ones they made, like the Wilt Chamberlain. Wilt Chamberlain's so big, when you take it out of the package, then you attach his legs to him. He's just torn in half right now.
Yeah.
But there are legs in the package, though?
Oh, yeah,
yes.
Oh, okay.
He stands real tall.
Yeah, where are you right now? Are you at, like, a hospital or something? Or?
I'm in a grocery store.
You're in the grocery store last week when you called us as well.
Well, I wasn't in the grocery store earlier.
Yeah.
But now I'm in a grocery store.
Sounds like a big grocery store.
It is. Called Smith's Food and Drugs.
Now, last week you were buying, I think you brought, what was it, ground meat and something, I don't know. What are you buying this week?
I don't know. I just got here.
Well, you just show up in the grocery store without an idea of what you want?
Yeah, I just look around.
Interesting. Usually people go with something in mind. Maybe even okay.
I got food in mind. Food.
Yeah, food.
And look at this. I'm so happy.
Why?
Why the Ed?
Well, you know, I am the number one Santa Claus in my class.
Oh, congratulations.
Yep, I know all the terms and technologies and everything.
Wow.
Now, does that mean you get the best mall?
No. I got the poor mall, I think.
Because you're black.
I just don't understand why, like, you have to train so long to be a Santa. Like, what do they teach you beyond, you know, just sit in that chair and say ho, ho, ho?
Well, you got to take tests, and you got to watch videos, and I still got another week and a half of training. Like, the rest of this week and one more week.
A lot of training.
Now,
and then they're going to cut me loose.
Now, do you know the history of Rudolph and all that? Is that part of the training?
Well, you know, you do got to learn a lot of that stuff. Like, I know that Santa Claus first started delivering packages in 1423.
I did not know that, yeah.
Wow.
That's pretty good. Yeah.
That was the first time that there was ever a Santa Claus sighting.
Well, how many reindeer pull his sleigh? Do you know that?
A bunch of them.
And can you name them?
Rudolph.
One.
Blitzen, okay, that's two. Comet.
Donner. Jupiter. Sleazy. Dopey.
Jupiter and Sleazy.
And Dopey.
Dopey.
Happy and Grumpy.
They're my favorites, yeah.
I think there's one named Tim, too.
Yeah.
Tim? Yeah, you're right, Tim.
Yeah,
they got one named Tim. They call him Timmy.
Yeah, Timmer. Tim.
You know, guess what I did today before? See, I've been doing this every day before I go to Santa Cruz for training.
Okay.
You know?
I TiVo.
You TiVo. Nice. Hey, what about TiVo last week? You had 118 yards rushing. That's pretty good, huh?
Hey, they got to let the kid just do what he does, man.
Yeah,
let's see what happens.
What the hell is TiVo?
TiVo, you go down on one knee like you're praying, TiVo.
Oh, so that's TiVoing?
Yes, that's TiVoing.
Yeah.
So
So he does that every morning before Santa Claus.
Huh. Yeah, I know.
So. Gets his mind right.
Do you make the cross symbol, like you touch your head and your chest and all that shit? You do that too?
No, I don't do that fake Sammy Sosa stuff.
Yeah.
All right. Well,
listen, 20 years ago this week, Magic Johnson lied to everybody and said he had HIV.
Yeah, save that for your show. I know you want to talk about that tomorrow on your show, right?
Oh, yeah. I thought this was my show.
No. It's the Hockey Kid Show. So that's tomorrow night, the Edge Show, 10 o'clock. We'll get into Magic. And I'll get your thoughts on the whole Magic debate and everything. And what else are we going to talk about tomorrow? I thought we had something else in the holster. I don't know.
I don't know.
But we'll just talk football or something. Because last week you wanted to do your second half preview, I should say. And we ran out of time because you had Uncle Remus call and Little Jay and stuff.
Oh, yeah. Oh, well, listen to this. If everybody listened last week, I gave them the exacta for the horse race, and they would have won $440.
Really?
Yeah. Joshua Meyer and Game On Dude. I said it last week on the show.
Oh, I don't even remember. Do you remember that, Larry? I don't know. Seems odd.
No, I don't remember.
Yeah. All right, Ed. Well,
you guys are bums, and I don't care.
Thanks, Ed. There he is. Ed Miller. And once again, go to backpagepress.com and get the Ed Super Deluxe T-shirt. It is lovely. Just gorgeous shirts, Ed. Right?
Yeah, I love it. And speaking of the Backpage Press kid, listen to this, Mike. I'll tell you this little story real quick. Yesterday, I wore my Backpage Press shirt to work. I wore the Bo Jackson one, you know, the Bo Knows Backpage Press, okay?
Yeah, it's a picture of Bo. He's got his shoulder pads on. He's got a bat across his shoulder, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's like an iconic picture and what have you, you know. It's like a famous picture of the Bo Jackson. Anyway, as you know here, Mike Dell, although it is November, it's been unseasonably warm the last few days. So, you know, I took off my sweatshirt because, you know, we were working in the warehouse and what have you, and it was a little warm or whatever. So I took off my sweatshirt and, you know, I had the Bo Jackson shirt on underneath. And it prompted the one kid that works in my department, a 20-year-old kid, to ask me, who is that black gentleman on your T-shirt? Now, I understand that the kid's 20 years old. But at the same time, like, how do you not know who Bo Jackson is? Like, honestly. You know what I'm saying, Mike Dell? I mean, sure, I don't know anything Selena Gomez sings, but I can recognize. You know what I mean? I know who she is. Like, how are you, like, so out of touch with pop culture that you don't know who Bo Jackson is? He's an icon, yes? Am I wrong about this?
If he's a sports fan, I mean, you should know who Bo Jackson is. But kids today, Larry, that's how you know you're getting old. You start saying things like kids today, you know?
Yeah.
Bo Jackson.
Uh-huh.
I think you really just need to come to grips with the fact that you're an old, old man.
Yeah. Well, you know, the fact that he was born, 4 months before I graduated high school.
Yeah.
That also tipped me off that I'm old.
I liked on Days of Thunder one time. Jacuzzi Pete, or the Dave, I forget who was even talking about. Maybe it had been Jacuzzi Pete. They're hanging around with a model on some shoot or something, and they found out that she was a post-Alf baby. She was born after 86.
Wow.
And Jacuzzi Pete said, a post-Alf baby.
Yeah, that's what I mean. He was born in 91. 91, Mike Bell.
Penguin Stanley Cup, and he's just getting born.
He's never been alive to see the Pirates with a winning record. You know what I mean? Like,
well,
that's how old I am.
92, they had a winning record, right? So
he was, you know, how old was he, though? One? Like, the point I'm trying to make is, you could tell him, hey, believe it or not, the Pirates were actually pretty goddamn good right before you were born. Okay, Gramps.
Yeah,
tell me another.
That's something
turn.
Else we wanted to get into with Dave, because you were going to make a big thing about how old athletes are terrible. Because I was bringing up the point earlier, like that when we were talking this afternoon, that I could name a bunch of athletes probably from the early 70s who would be iconic that you wouldn't know. You know, because you're born in, 73 or so, right?
Yeah.
So it's the same situation for this kid, you know?
It is, but at the same time, like, we, you know, Just because you can name a guy doesn't mean shit to me, Mike Dell. Once again, yeah, we were going to talk about this with the Dave, but I know with Brandon there, it just wasn't going to happen. But these guys from the 50s suck. They fucking suck, Mike Dell. Once
well,
again,
Ed,
you could talk. Go ahead.
Well, I was going to say, Ed has his theories about athletes. What year does he use for the cutoff? Is it 1970 or is it 19? I think he says anything before 1970 doesn't count, right? So
yeah,
saying?
Sure. Okay.
Yeah. So that's all.
I'm with that. Yeah. Because, listen, you could talk about, Bart Starr. What year did Bart Starr play, Mike Dell?
The 60s. Yeah, he's in the 60s.
Okay. Well, who was, Dieter Brock? When did Dieter Brock play?
He was in the 80s, Dieter Brock.
Did he really?
Yeah, Dieter Brock. When the Chicago Bears won the Super Bowl, they beat Dieter Brock in the playoffs that year.
How about, Slinging Sammy Baugh? When did he play?
40s and 50s, right?
Okay, 40s or 50s. All right, perfect. Let's talk about Slinging Sammy Baugh. Because I got news for you, Mike Dell. If I was alive back in the 40s or 50s, I'd make Slinging Sammy Baugh look like a bitch. I would pass all over that fucking team.
Yes,
I would.
Slinging Sammy Baugh was tremendous. He was a punter, he was a quarterback, and he played defensive back.
But everybody sucked back then. These are all guys who were selling shoes and shit.
Slinging Sammy Baugh would have wore you out. He was like an 85-year-old dude. NFL Films was interviewing him, and he's just a badass. You don't mess with Slinging Sammy Baugh. You know?
Okay. Listen, dude. I'm 6'5". I'm over 215, 220.
You can't run with a damn. You are slower than a tax refund. You have no lateral movement at all.
I'd be throwing guys
None.
Around with one arm, eating a sandwich with the other arm as I'm walking down the field, scoring the ninth touchdown in the first quarter because I'm dominating that league
every year.
I would have won the Heisman Trophy 4 years in a row, and then I would have came into the pros and just dominated. I probably would have finished with 130,000 passing yards and about 9,000 touchdowns.
So if I can just summarize your argument, your thesis statement would be before 1970, athletes didn't exist. That's basically
no. I'm saying anything before anything 1950s or before, it's just bogus. Put me on the Montreal Canadiens back in 1945, and I got 10,000 goals that season. I'm crushing everybody. I'm playing goalie and forward. Yeah,
you couldn't even stand up on skates. You know, let's be honest. You can't skate with a pan. But,
how long does it take to learn how to... Not that long. It wouldn't take that long to learn how to skate.
Rocket Richard would eat your lunch. You know?
Rocket Richard would eat my fist because I'd bash him in the mouth, and then I'd score a goal, and then I'd bash him in the mouth again, and then maybe I'd strap on the pads and go play goalie for a period because I already got a 30-goal lead.
So basically... If not for fate, you would have been a superstar athlete. If you were only born 50 years earlier, Larry.
Exactly. I could have. I probably would have won the World Series in 4 games. I would have pitched
probably.
And hit Babe Ruth style.
Well, I'm sorry we missed it.
Or nothing. Absolutely. I would have dominated back then. They're nothing. Nothing.
Yeah.
I'd bitch slap Dick Butkus. I'm telling you.
You know, he's still alive, Dick Butkus. So what are you going to get two together?
Got to be 130 at this point.
Hey, Dick Butkus was on an episode of Taxi as well.
That's even more reason to slap him in his mouth.
In fact, it was the episode written by our buddy Barry Rabinowitz. You know Barry?
Oh, really?
He wrote the episode with Dick Butkus. Yeah. All right. Anyway, what else is going on, Larry? Because we got to get you off this nonsense about you being an athlete, because that's just ridiculous.
It's not nonsense. Once again, I know you like to portray to everybody that I'm this big oafish dude, and
yes.
You know I'm not saying I'm not, but
yeah.
You know I'm. It's not like I'm not athletic either. It's not like I can't throw a ball or hit a ball.
Yeah, you can throw a ball. I'll give you that. You can throw a ball, but anything involving movement, I would say no. Not really. Not something you want to get into. But yeah, Larry can't throw a football. He can throw a baseball. You know, but yeah, movement.
Dude, I could 3-step drop all over the NFL back in the 50s. I'm telling you, I would have dominated that league.
All right.
I would tell you, you know what the biggest, you know what the biggest problem would have been back then? My wide receivers wouldn't have been good enough to keep up with my balls.
That's right.
That's all I'm saying. They'd be dropping shit all over the place. They couldn't handle the spiral.
Not good enough to keep up with your balls. And then, once again, you're going to have to live with those jokes the rest of your life.
I won't hang up on you.
What else is going on, Larry? What else do we need to talk about? TV and movies. You reviewed the Paranormal Activity last week for us. Did you see anything this week?
I don't think so. And if I did, I'm saving it for Herb Show. Take that, Mike Dell.
What the hell? You're saving it for Herb Show?
Yeah, we're doing a movie special this week.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, because Larry does it with Security Guy Irv on Fridays. You do a little show there. And a movie-themed show. What's the theme of the show?
We're just going to talk movies. Just movies. We're going to do
No particular, we do our little top 11.
No. We're just going to talk favorite movies. And, you know, he's seen some newer movies at the theater because Irv's, I don't know, I'm sure you don't listen, but Irv's the hub of Las Vegas. He's like the new Wayne Newton. He's Mr. Las Vegas. He's always at shows. He's always got front row tickets to fights. He's always at the movies and concerts. And Irv's got it going on. So Irv goes to the movies a lot. So he's going to review some of the newer movies. Like I know he went to see that Justin Timberlake one. And I don't even remember what it's called, but he just went to see that. So, yeah, we're going to talk some movies. And I'm trying to think. We might have somebody on the show, but I don't remember. I don't know.
Well, that's Friday, so tune in for that. And then what about TV? Anything TV-related that you've been watching lately?
TV? No, because no. There hasn't been so much TV on because I've been going to bed early the last few nights since it took me I've been trying Monday night and Tuesday night. I've tried Clerks 2 both nights, and I only get like about 20 minutes in, and I'm out.
Yeah, that'll do it. That'll put your
hair
out. Well, I do have a story that a pal of mine relayed to me just this past week about a certain actor that you like, and it's kind of a famous little story, and would you like to hear the tale? I won't tell you who the actor is until I'm done with the story.
Are you going to ruin this guy for me now?
No. It's a funny story. It's
All right. Yeah.
All right. So my pal there, he's a good friend, and he has a friend who was on an airplane with this actor, and they hit it off on the airplane, and they exchanged phone numbers. Okay. As you know, if you're an actor, that's what you do. You hit on the ladies on airplanes, and then you say, "Hey, I'm famous. Give me your phone number." And then that's how you do it, Larry. Right.
Usually, yeah.
Yeah. So they exchange the phone numbers, they call, they get together, and he says, "Why don't you come over to my house?" You know? And she's like, "All right, you know, I'll show up and we'll hang out." So she goes over to his house, and he opens the door, and he greets her. He's shirtless, and he's wearing pajama pants, and he's holding a bong.
Nice.
All right? Yeah, and he's stoned out of his mind, all right?
Okay.
He just looks stoned, you know, he's acting good. So they go into the apartment, you know, and they start, I think there was some making out involved. So I'm not, and then at one point he gets up and he disappears into the kitchen. And he's in there a very long time. So long, in fact, that the young woman thinks, well, maybe I should just leave, you know. Yet right when she's about to get up and leave, he comes out of the kitchen and he's holding a bottle of olive oil.
Uh-oh.
And he says, "Do I have a treat for you?" And he's basically implying that he wants to use the olive oil on the lady.
Okay.
And she left.
That's the story?
That's the story.
Okay.
Now, would you care to guess who that actor was?
Corey Feldman.
No, but that's a solid guess. No, we're looking for Anthony Michael Hall.
Oh, goddammit.
Anthony Michael Hall, yeah.
AMH wouldn't do that, Mike, though.
Yeah. That, how does that make you feel, that Anthony Michael Hall wanted to lube someone up in olive oil and have his way with him? There's nothing wrong with that.
Yeah. That sounds about right. He sounds like a real douche in real life. Mm-hmm. He just got arrested for trying to beat up his neighbors or something.
Really?
Huh. Yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah.
But really, if you're going to, if you're going to use an oil for lube, olive oil is a healthy oil. So
no,
don't stay away from cottonseed oil. You know, they use that in a lot of cottonseed. Yeah.
I don't think that really applies if you're not like ingesting it. Like if you're just going to rub it on your skin, I don't think it's really going to affect so much.
Yeah.
I think if you're just going, you know, topical, I think you could just go ahead and you're safe with Crisco even if you want to.
What about like a motor oil? You don't want to do that, right?
No, because that's toxic.
Yeah.
You get that in your mouth or whatever, and, you know, you could be in the hospital.
Yeah, that's probably not.
Bye-bye. Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
And that was a good Anthony Michael Hall story. I enjoyed that.
Hold on. We're not just brushing over this all of a sudden. Now, do you know this girl?
I don't know the person who turned down the olive oil rub. No.
Uh-huh. Now, let me ask you this. You know the friend of the girl, though.
I know a friend of the friend of the girl.
Okay, now he's the friend of the friend of the girl. Other initials, M.F.
M.F.
Yeah.
Why is that?
I'm just asking. Do you know who I'm referring to?
No, I'm trying to think who that would possibly be. M.F.
The M would be a state, and the F would be for some...
Oh. No. All
right. Okay, fair enough. All
right. But M would be a state. That's all I needed. But, that's a good story. I don't have any other stories. I haven't watched anything on TV, really. You don't watch The Boardwalk Empire, so we can't talk about that. You don't watch The Board to Death, so we can't talk about that.
I don't have HBO.
Yeah.
I got my Wii fixed, though.
Congratulations. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. I went up to the Walmart, and I got one of those cans of air.
Oh, yeah, the cans of air, yeah.
Yeah, and I just blew out the Wii, and then it came back on again.
Oh, you just blew out the Wii once again. You're going to have to live with that as long as
Now listen here, Mike Bell.
Uh-huh.
You know, you like Michael Jackson. I don't start busting your balls over that kind of thing.
I don't like Michael Jackson. You know, I just researched him and realized, oh, yeah, that stuff was all lies. But, yeah, So if you want me to research the Sandusky case and tell you whether it's true or not, I'd be happy to.
I don't have any connection to Jerry Sandusky.
All right.
I just feel bad for Joe Pa. You know what I mean? Because the 2,000 years he's been on this earth are all tainted now.
It's unfortunate. You think, well, if only he would have retired a couple years earlier. But no, this would have came out eventually anyway, and it would have,
exactly.
But anyway, well, whatever. Let's leave it.
Now, let me ask you this. Did you listen to the Dave show this week?
I haven't had a chance yet.
Because I'll be honest with you. ZacuScore is the absolute worst guest in the history of podcasting.
Oh, that's
didn't want to say it to Dave. Sure, he might be a nice guy or whatever, but he is so dull. 99% of the time, Green Bay covers the spread in November. You know, it's like, give me a break, nerd.
He likes the stats and the computers. I don't think that's any reason to, disparage him. There you go.
It's so boring, though. It makes for the worst radio because he has no personality at all.
It better if Aki Zak got drunk and then passed out during the show? That would be great. You'd have no problem with that.
Yeah, that's funny. Yeah. Everybody laughs at that. Nobody's ever laughing at Zaki Bor.
Fair enough. He's actually a good kid, Aki Zak. He's a good kid.
He's a nice guy, but he's just boring as shit. Like, I don't need to hear him. If the Dave doesn't get the Ed on it soon, I'm going to be upset. And you know what else I wanted to talk to the Dave about, and we never got around to it? We need more Huey and Applesauce and less of that NFL bullshit, because I don't really care anymore about the Rams, the Titans, and the Buccaneers.
Well, Larry, you realize they do the show for a football audience, not necessarily for you specifically. You
I know, but I want it for me specifically. I want Dave the Thunder back, but Feeney out and Rank in. That's what I want.
I wanted to I meant to ask Dave about the David Feeney, because I would like to get a Feeney update, see what he's up doing. And then we have Joyless Joey's number on file, and we were thinking about just cold calling Joyless Joey with Dave on the air and seeing how, we could put those together. So there's a lot of stuff we still got to do with Dave, The time goes so quick when he's on. You know, it just goes quick. Yeah.
All right, so I'm looking up Feeney right now and seeing what he's doing. Well, he's writing a show, consulting producer on something called Love Bites. Do you know what Love Bites is?
Yeah, that was on NBC, and I don't know if it got picked up again or not. There's a few episodes that aired. I remember Jennifer Love Hewitt was on, like, the first episode as a guest, I believe.
Oh, Greg Grunberg, he's very good.
Yeah, I know that.
Grunberg, yeah.
But Mr. Feeney, I got my Feensters Union T-shirt, and it's a fine T-shirt. It's Balls and Bukowski.
Yeah, well, the only thing worse than Zachy Bor is David Feeney. I'll be honest.
Oh, my goodness.
He's terrible. He's the biggest pompous piece of shit that ever put a microphone in front of his face.
I love Feeney.
He's such an arrogant asshole. He's just so arrogant.
What was my favorite joke he did? They're protecting the treasure.
Protecting the treasure, yeah.
Hilarious.
Yeah, so good.
Yeah. That was my favorite joke.
I don't even remember. How did that come about? He was at a Dodger game.
They were at a baseball game. Yeah, they were at the Dodger game. And the lady next to him was telling ghost stories or something, right? And she was saying, well, these ghosts are there. And she goes, why would there be ghosts there? And Feeney, he was just overhearing that conversation and just leaned back and said, maybe they're protecting the treasure.
Yeah.
It's great.
Funny,
it's a great joke. All right.
We're on a show.
Are we officially out in more minutes to kill?
It's 5 minutes, but by the time we wrap everything up and, Well, you got something you want to say?
I don't know. I'm thinking like we had something else. Didn't we have something else in the holster to talk about?
No. Nothing I have written down. I got old school versus new school and Backpage Press.
All right. Speaking of the Backpage Press, once again, backpagepress.com, go buy the Ed Super Deluxe T-shirt, get the Czech Republic T-shirt, the David Feenster, the Feensters Union T-shirt, Jacuzzi Pete, but while you're over there, do yourself a favor and go to like the blog section. I tweeted this out the other day. Corey Seymour, the guy behind Backpage Press, he put out some tremendous photos of his basement where he makes all the T-shirts. It's fascinating stuff, isn't it great, Larry? Get an inside
glimpse.
It is
cool.
Yeah,
and for everybody who thinks that Backpage Press is this major corporation, it's not. He's literally a guy working in an unfinished basement making one shirt at a time. So when everybody's bashing him about this, that, and everything, this guy takes it hard, Mike Dow. He does. He takes it personally.
And let me just say this. I'm big on the truth, man. So I'm not going to support a fella who I think is a bum. I don't know. He's good people. So support Corey Seymour and Backpage Press.
I agree.
Yeah,
and stop bashing him. If you don't like anything, just keep it to your fucking self.
That's right.
He doesn't come knock the dick out of your mouth at work, so don't worry about what he's up to. If you don't like this shirt, then just keep it to yourself.
The shirts are great. I'm wearing my Czech Republic one right now. How would you describe them? They're like, they seem softer than a normal T-shirt.
Definitely softer. Loom spun cotton, I think, is how he describes the shirts.
They're tremendous.
Cotton. They're not like your typical feeling T-shirt. They're very soft, like tissue paper. They're very nice. Yeah. But I have five Backpage Press shirts, Mike Dell. Five.
I now I'm a proud owner of four since I got the Eds.
Four shirts. So that's nine shirts between us.
And we got to get the Ed. We got to sell the Ed shirt to make him like feel like a celebrity. Because the Ed, he thinks no one's buying a shirt and no one likes him. And, that's probably true. But let's buy the shirt because it's a good shirt. Make the Ed happy. Make Corey happy. And then sooner or later, Larry the T-shirt. It's only a matter of time.
Yeah. We don't need Larry the T-shirt. Nobody's buying.
No, I think we do. I think we do need Larry the T-shirt. What would you want on your T-shirt, Larry? What kind of design?
Nothing. A coffin. Maybe.
Something like Roseanne Barr, and nothing like Roseanne related because you love Roseanne.
No.
Well, what about Rachel Lee Cook? How about we put Rachel Lee Cook on a T-shirt?
Well, that's fine, but that's a Rachel Lee Cook T-shirt then.
If we ever do make another, because in the old days we made LCS T-shirts, and I still have some. Remember, we were going to give them away for prizes. We never do that.
Yeah.
Why don't we do that? But if we ever make new ones, it's going to be a chimp smoking a cigarette.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. It's going to be great.
Because our buddy Bernie had designed a couple different logos for us, and you shit on all of them immediately.
Yeah, well, I'm like, well, why did you make a logo? Because when I make a T-shirt, I want it to be a chimp smoking a cigarette. Yeah.
But that doesn't even make any sense.
It's a chimp smoking a cigarette.
See, that would have been fine for LCS, the website, but this is LCS, the radio show now.
Mm. Neither
okay,
one of us a chimp wearing headphones smoking a cigarette.
Yeah. All right. There's no cigarettes. I don't understand the cigarette.
Yeah. It makes them look tough.
We don't smoke. We don't smoke.
But it makes them look tough.
How come when I smoked, it didn't make me look tough? It made me look like an asshole.
Yeah.
Oh, Larry, you got to get rid of that.
It just makes you, like, smell and stuff. But for a chimp.
I know, but cool for a chimp, though?
Yeah, a chimp smoking, that's pretty cool.
Huh. I guess. All right. Yeah. So, yeah, go to Backpage Press and buy a shirt. Yeah,
I like looking into the downstairs basement there that he's got, and all the like the silk screen like boards and stuff. It's fascinating. I love that kind of.
Yeah,
stuff.
Yeah, it's kind of cool to see how the whole shindig goes down. Yeah,
mm-hmm.
I recommend getting the George Carlin shirt. That's me.
Yeah, George Carlin. He used to make a Bill Hicks T-shirt. We got to get him on that. Make a Bill Hicks shirt.
Oh, really? Bill Hicks. Yeah. That's your boy.
That's right. It is my boy, Bill Hicks. All right, Larry. Well, once again, we got to tell people Cousin Brandon. Thanks, Cousin Brandon. You can follow him at Judy Bloom.
Yeah.
And is he still doing the
yeah,
Mr.
Vanity
Hipster blog?
State.
Oh, Vanity State. But is he doing Mr. Hipster at all anymore?
I haven't seen Mr. Hipster in a while.
That was cousinbrandon.wordpress.com, I believe, right?
Uh-huh.
And then Vanity State, the Tumblr page where he takes the pictures of vanity license plates and puts them up. That's always entertaining. And our buddy Zippy the Wonder Chimp was on like last week or so with one Dr.
Yeah.
Chimp. Wonder Chimp.
Yeah,
so
right.
That's good. And by the way, I told Zippy and Matt that in the future we might just we're just going to call them maybe out of the blue to play a celebrity guest Mike Dale's Pants. Like maybe,
oh, look at that.
Yeah, if we ever, like tonight would have been a perfect time to do it, because we can dial out now. We can just call Zippy and say, hey, play guest. We even still have that theme song, because we haven't played that in a long time.
What, the Super Terrific song? Is that what you're talking about?
No, the guest Mike Dale's Pants song. Like if we ever
oh,
did
Mike
that again.
Dale's Pants? Let's see. Yeah, we still have Mike Dale's Pants.
So I'm thinking that's what we should do. Like maybe once a week we'll do a celebrity version. We'll just place a call to like a former guest or something, and just have him on and guest the color of my pants, and then that's it. You know, and just hang up, and that'll be it.
All right. We could call Matthew Barnum.
Yeah, yeah. We'll call Matthew Barnum. See, do you think he would remember us if we called Matthew Barnum? It's been like two and a half years. Yeah.
Oh, fuck no. I barely remember us.
Yeah. All right, so that's Cousin Brandon at Judy Bloom. Go our buddy Dave Damashek at Damashek on the Twitters and Damashek.com, NFL.com, the NFL Network. Listen to him. He's the tops. And then we got to thank you, Larry, for being the tops. Your Twitter handle, of course, is at I Love Sean Leahy. Right.
Yeah, there's a couple underscores in there somewhere, but I don't even remember where.
And then you're also at Larry LCS. You've got two Twitter accounts because you're just that popular. And then, of course, I'm at Michael Paul Dell for all your alternative news and frightening stories. And,
uh-huh. You were thinking about maybe dropping the middle, maybe dropping the Paul?
No, because I kind of have to do that because that's my writer name because the computer guy, Michael Dell.
Uh-huh.
Like,
why can't you be at Mike Dell?
But I wanted it to be for when, you know, the books come out and stuff. So I'm going to be writing under the name Michael Paul Dell. So,
mm-hmm.
See what I'm saying?
I see what you're saying.
Yeah, or we could just come up with an entirely new name for me, too. We could do that.
How about Slappy McBallsack?
Once again, really? do you want me to go there?
Yes, go there. Yeah.
But, yeah, you know, you can't have – I can't be Michael Dell because everyone's going to say, oh, you make those computers. No, I don't make the computers.
All right.
Jerk. Yeah. So you have to put the middle initial in there, the middle name. But I'll be happy to change my entire name if you can come up with something good.
You should change it to Bill Gates.
I like the sound of that.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah. William Gates. That'd be nice. Yeah.
Or is there a guy who, like, invented a computer that was a colossal failure and no one knows? Maybe I can change my name to him.
You could be, Jimmy Commodore 64. How about that?
Do you know who Philo T. Fassbinder is? If I say that name, Philo T. Fassbinder, do you know who that is?
I don't know.
He's the guy who invented television, but no one knows who he is.
Really?
Fassbinder. Yeah.
That's my hero, then.
Yeah, exactly. But why is it that... Well, because he came up with the idea and then other people ripped him off for it and stuff. But yeah, Philo, I think that's his name. But isn't that something like that's the most pivotal invention in, you know, mankind, really, in the last 100 years? TV, communications, and whatnot, and no one even knows his name.
What about that Tesla guy? Didn't he invent the radio too?
I can do a whole show on Tesla if you want. Think about Tesla. He's a great fella. And he died alone with pigeons all over his room. Yeah.
But, is there a but to it?
No, Nikola Tesla's a great guy. I think he is, like, he was taken advantage of. You know, he died penniless because, you know, people ripped him off and he didn't profit from his inventions. And then as soon as he died, Larry, what did the feds do? They ran in and stole all his diaries and his work and his works and his papers. They stole them all because they didn't want his inventions getting out. Maybe next week, Larry. I don't know what we're going to do next week. Maybe I'll see if I can get my buddy Pat Piccarelli on. Would you like that? No, you don't want Pat on next? Really?
I don't care. Yeah, do it. You know, hey, whatever you want
to
do, Mike.
Is there anyone else you wanted to have on next week?
No. Not really.
You're just a bitter, bitter man.
I'm not bitter. How is that bitter? I'm not bitter about anything.
Right. So we'll try and get Pat on next week, maybe. And maybe, or I could just do, we haven't done conspiracy in a long time. Maybe I'll fire up a conspiracy again. So we'll do some.
Yeah. And you know what comes out Friday, Mike? The final Harry Potter comes out on DVD, so I'm excited about that.
Oh, good Lord.
I'm sure we'll talk about that next week.
Harry Potter?
Yeah, Harry Potter's good stuff. I'm sorry, I'm sorry Humphrey Bogart isn't in it, but it's still a good movie. Yeah.
All right, Larry. Wrap it up.
That's it, we're done. We thanked everybody, and next week, maybe Pat Piccarelli, maybe... Not. We don't know. What about the Stan Marsh guy?
Once again, you're confusing the two names. Roger Marsh and Stan Gordon.
All right. Stan Gordon, then. I thought we were going to
get... Yeah, I could try and get Stan Gordon on.
I want a Space Monkey guy on. I want the guy that I stayed awake for on. Which one was
that? That's Stan Gordon. Now, why do you want a Space Monkey guy on? Because every time I'm like, I'm going to get a Space Monkey guy on, you're like, no, I don't want a Space... Why now do you want a Space Monkey guy on the show?
I can't tell you that.
Because you want to sleep during the show.
What?
That's exactly why you want to. That's exactly why you want to come on, because you say you can sleep during the show.
that makes no... I don't even... I'm insulted by that accusation. I won't stand for that sort of thing.
Ridiculous.
That is just... that's insulting to me, Mike Dell. Insulted. So.
What about Maria Heller? Would you mind if I got Maria Heller back on the show? Remember Maria?
No. Oh,
she's
yeah.
Great. And there's a lot of stuff going on in the world. Yeah, that's right. She's an artist. But we could talk to her about Occupy Wall Street, the Fukushima disaster. There's a lot of stuff going on in the world that Maria's on top of. We could talk to her about.
Now, when you say we mean you.
Well, yeah, probably.
Yeah, exactly. So, yeah, get her on. Yeah.
All right.
See what she thinks about John Tavares and Occupy Wall Street.
Yeah. We'll see.
All right. And, because I'd like to get somebody on the show one time.
Well, hey, book a guest.
How about Anthony
Michael Hall? Get Anthony Michael Hall on. Because remember, you were trying to get Anthony Michael Hall on the show, so get him on, and then we'll ask him about that olive oil story.
Yeah. Well, he won't remember because he was high.
Yeah.
Either that or, you know, he does that with everybody. And you know, yeah. I do that at least twice a day. You think he gets a lot of ass?
Yeah, he's Anthony Michael Hall. 50
I
yards.
I know, but like...
50 yards. Or 50
know,
feet.
Besides being the bit part in The Dark Knight, like, when's the last time he's done a movie? You think he's still getting Rusty money?
That's right, you know? I'm sure he invites the lady over, and the movie is, like, on the TV, he's got, like, weird signs playing. And he's like, oh, I'm sorry, I didn't know that was on. You know?
Yeah. I could see that, them. Yeah. Yeah, I could definitely.
Let me turn that off, and then it'll hit the wrong. Or he'll turn off the DVD, and here on TV, he'll have it rigged that, you know, like National Lampoon's is playing. Oh, look! Oh, I'm sorry.
Is that six pack?
Holy hell, I didn't know this was on. Remember Six Pack?
No, I don't remember Six Pack, no.
It was that racing movie with Kenny Rogers. With the
that one. No,
yeah.
I don't remember it. I don't remember the Kenny Rogers movie.
Yeah, he was like a stock car racer, and he had a bunch of kids as his pit crew, and Anthony Michael Hall was one of the kids. And Diane Lane
was
in that movie.
Diane Lane, really?
Yeah.
Like a young Diane Lane.
Yeah, very young Diane Lane.
Ooh,
yeah.
Let me tell you something about Diane Lane.
Yeah, exactly. That's what I'm saying. Now all of a sudden, Six Pack's not so funny anymore.
Yeah, maybe I'll hit the Netflix Six Pack.
Yeah. It's terrible, but yeah, a young Diane Lane.
Yeah.
I think her name was Cherry in the movie. Cherry. Ooh, no, I mean, that was The Outsiders.
Yeah, I was going to say that's The Outsiders, yeah. Hey,
her
no,
name was something. She had a good name, though. So, all right, I'm out of here. I got to go to bed, you know. I got to get up at 5.
All right, Larry.
All right, bye. Oh, yeah. Next week, Somebody and Larry Knapp. And we'll be back. Thanks, Dave and Brandon and the Ed. Oh, yeah, go. Yeah, we never thanked the Ed, though, Mike Dell. At the Ed from Vegas on the Twitter.
That's right. At the Ed from Vegas.
Yeah. So you can follow him. And don't forget, you can go over to Damashek.com, sign up for the message board, and play all the Ed's games because he only talks about them on every show that he ever appears on. So at least you will know what the hell he's talking about. So do that, too. All right. Next week, we'll be back next Wednesday. Until then, pass the gin, Governor.
As in trousers, or pants as in really fast sports cars.
Pants on the ground, pants on the ground, looking like a fool with your pants on the ground.
Could you use pants in a sentence?
Please try on this pair of pants.
Well, that's no help at all. Okay?
It's Mike Dell's pants.
Thank you very much.